I did hope, for the sake of our country, that Donald Trump might show some interest in taking the job seriously. That he might come to feel the weight of the office and discover some reverence for the democracy that had been placed in his care. But he never did. For close to 4 years now, he has shown no interest in putting in the work, no interest in finding common ground, no interest in using the awesome power of his office to help anyone but himself and his friends. No interest in treating the presidency as anything but one more reality show that he can use to get the attention he craves. Donald Trump hasn't grown into the job because he can't. And the consequences of that failure are severe.
Bullshit walking when real niggas talking. Let me catch this shit right here. My people's Picasso is in here with the Boss Mac Topsoil tonight. What's up with you people?
What's up with it, big dog?
Hey, man, I'm happy to have you in this motherfucker, man.
Man, I'm happy to be here, big dog. I appreciate the invitation always.
It's hot as fuck. It's hot as fuck. Man, and your man, you brought your mans with you.
Oh, yeah, my man Hayes OG, man. Shout out my boy Hayes, man.
He came up in here with the Deuce and the fire kush.
Hey, on that beautiful struggle that got to do, the man that's behind the vocals, man, that's this man right here.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Yeah, that's this man. He can sing, bro.
Okay, yeah, that's where I remember that name from.
He got hella vocals, bro.
Okay, I remember that name.
Sing and rap.
I remember that name.
That's my boy. That's my bro.
Hey, now, y'all niggas do know that I featured that song on the podcast, you know, that song on the podcast.
Oh,
you know
yeah, I need a percentage see, of nigga, that, man. You didn't even tell me that.
Hey, man, I don't think we made no paper off of it, man.
Nah, I'm just joking, man.
Because we ain't getting the views like that, but
nah,
let
I'm
me tell you.
I'm just fucking with you, man. I'm just fucking with you.
Hey,
you
man.
Know, I ain't worried about that shit, man. You
hey,
know,
hey, man. Hey, you know, man, I just try to always.
That's love, though, bro. I appreciate that, man.
Hey,
you got
man.
A hell of a platform, my man.
Hey, man, I'm out here waving the flag at all times. All my peoples know they fuck. They know I be playing your shit on here, man.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You understand me? But anyway, welcome to the Ball Smack Podcast. Ball Smack Gnosis Live. I'm in here with my peoples, Picasso. And my people's Hayes over here is we doing our thing, man, right here tonight. The show is brought to you by Ball Smack Streetwear.
Yes, indeed.
Go through Ball Smack Streetwear and cop some Ball Smack Streetwear. You see Picasso got on the Compton's Righteous joint.
Yeah.
You know, that's a collaboration effort, indeed. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, Ball Smack is always bringing you, man, fine garments, man, with powerful slogans on them.
Yes,
to make bitches pay attention to you when you're out there doing your thing. And if you need that in your life, you want bitches to stop you, take a picture of you.
Yes, sir.
Put on some Ball Smack Streetwear, man. Go through there and cop something now. Yeah. Also, y'all know the Ball Smack Topsoil is offering a one-on-one game. If you need some game, you need some counseling, you're having problems with your bitches, you want to holler at me. You get in my DMs. Get in my DMs. You know right there, man. We got hourly rates. I'ma take care of you.
That part.
I'ma look at the man. When you come to me, You tell me your problems, I'm going to look at it like it's a game. I see what's going on in the game. I'm going to tell you exactly what play to run so you can score on this bitch. I'm trying to told you, man, listen to what I'm talking about. Your peoples ain't going to guide you in the right way because they out there competing with you, man. They don't want you to be having a lot of bitches and be managing them properly. They want you to have problems. But see, when you fuck with me, I got your best interest involved because you broke bread with me. So I want to see you win. And when you win, I win. Fuck with the boss, Mike Top, yes, sir, out there, man. Y'all niggas, man. Once again, I'm happy to have y'all niggas in here right now,
it's a
man.
Blessing, bro.
Let's get it popping. Since the Picasso was on here last time, salute. Since the Picasso was on here last time, this nigga that dropped 2 projects of fire lyrics out of Bompton hip hop for niggas.
One of the coldest.
And you know what I'm saying? I don't think a lot of niggas is seeing it and acknowledging it like it's supposed to be done. But as a music connoisseur, I put my eye on it. I seen it a long time ago.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And I think it's only a matter of time, you understand me?
Yes, sir.
And, you know, how has it been since you put out them first 2? Because it's been this year, you know, January, you came out with that first one. How niggas received that shit, man?
I mean, since the beginning of this year, man, something just sparked me. I'm like, I got to take off, bro. I gotta stop bullshitting. I got to be more consistent, so... The reception has been, true hip hop connoisseurs like yourself, they gravitate towards me.
They give me my props for it.
That's really who I do it for, you know what I'm saying?
Because,
you know, I'm investing more in this music shit than I'm getting back. Honestly, I'm not doing it for a check or nothing like that. If that was the case, I would have been stopped. I'm not getting shit from this shit.
But
just the love, you know, because I grew up a big fan of all the lyricists, man, from Pharoah Monch, Dr. Doom, Rakim, Chubb Rock, you know, Black Thought, Nas, AZ. Like, I'm a Bompton nigga, man, but I'm a big fan of East Coast lyricism.
Just
lyricism overall, even niggas on the West Coast, Trey D, Planet Asia, you know, Freestyle Fellowship, you know what I mean? The stuff y'all was doing, Compton Righteous back in the day.
Okay, let me stop you. Okay, for my peoples who don't know who you are, who is Picasso?
Picasso, man, I'm just a dude, man, from 150th Street, man, in Cahita, man, from Roy Campanella area, Compton, west side of Compton, off Rosecrans and Central. You know, laid back, reserved type of dude, smooth dude. I don't do much talking.
Yeah.
People might have their own perception of me because of that, but people that know me, they know what's up with me, you know what I'm saying?
Like, yeah.
I'm not a braggadocious dude. I'm very humble and laid back and smooth. Unless you try to make me be something else, and then I just react to the situation. I accommodate you. You know what I'm saying? I'm good with doing that.
That's right. You know, that's right.
I'm just a product of my environment. Trying to make the best of it, man. I'm good at that, man.
That's right.
Best out of worst situation. I'm still in the struggle. I don't live that big old braggadocious, outlandish rap life. These niggas be perpetrating their living.
Uh-huh.
I still work a 9-to-5, you know what I mean?
I feel you. As most niggas should.
You know? I mean, I got fired from my job recently, though. I had to punch this nigga out. He spit on me and shit.
What?
He spit on me, bro.
At the job.
Yeah. So, I mean, I kind of blanked out and punched him out a little bit, and they said I used excessive force. They said I didn't abide.
Wait a minute. That motherfucker spit on you at the time.
Spit on me, bro.
What was it? Can you discuss? Do you got a lawsuit happening on
this
motherfucker?
Can you
say the name of the company, this is what this was?
Again? I mean, I was subcontracted by the security company to work for Metro. You know
okay,
I mean?
Okay.
I was doing armed security for the rail line and shit.
Okay. So this was a person in the
supposed to be a traveler, just a person
okay,
supposed
yeah,
to just
so
get on the fucking
heathens
train.
You're dealing with
home
heathens out here.
Man, you know that, man. And I be in his uniform, they get it twisted, bro. I'm like, man, y'all don't know. Y'all dealing with a real nigga, man. I'm not a Boy Scout. I'm not a police in training. Like, I'm a real nigga from the west side of Bompton, man. I just try to be professional and productive for 8 hours of the day.
It's a crazy world, man. Motherfuckers be like...
I know it's spiritual, though, man.
It's a crazy world, man. Yeah, it's a... Bro, I feel like... I feel like negative is a the negative energy in the air is at an all time.
That shit
high
is demonic, bro.
Right now,
it's
evil is in the air right now, sparking. But yo, okay, now musically, man, I see you right in there with these niggas, man. I keep my eye on the game, man. I seen Conway and Westside Gunn them from the gate.
Yeah.
I seen them from
the
gate.
Yeah, shout out Griselda to them, man.
And
BSF.
And I ain't gonna lie, man. I fucked with them from the gate. Mm-hmm. But I still see a weakness in them.
Yeah, what is it?
It's a weakness in them.
Is it they lyrical capabilities or
no,
just
it's
they
not the
just
lyrics. It's not the lyrics. It's not
they
the
marketing
lyrics
or it's just the way they're approaching it
it's,
or
it's the beats. It's the beats. Oh, now man. Here's the thing about the beats. Now this is what I'm finna point out. See, this is what you're not seeing.
I like the beats
here's
though.
Here's the difference.
Mm-hmm.
See them niggas. See, they on some Rock Marciano, Marcy type shit. And it's cool, but them niggas is acting like low end do not count. And low end count. Yeah. Now, here's what I mean by low end. Now, you can say, oh, well, man, they beats got that
Alchemist,
that
Derringer sound.
But see, Alchemist.
They sound more New York than niggas that's from the borough.
Now,
they from
Alchemist,
Buffalo.
Alchemist be having low end in some of his beats.
Yeah, he sample a lot, though.
Right?
He do a lot of sampling.
Okay.
Shout out to Alchemist, Uncle Al. I need
now. When I get to talking about beats like that with low end, I'm in a dimension, a tribe called Quest.
Yeah. Q-tip.
You see, they shit
Q-tip
be subbing, bro.
It was melodic.
While it still have that feel.
Yeah.
It's the subbing.
I get it.
Count,
they on
bro.
Some more grimy, dark shit. They on that. I get it. I get what you're saying. It's like the grimy sound.
That subbing communicates some shit to niggas.
Oh, definitely. Alone, without the lyrics.
The subbing.
It brings up your vibrations.
And,
you know what I'm saying? It makes you feel good.
When you come with the proper lyrical content, that's why Quest fucked a lot of gangsters fucked with Quest. Gangsters didn't even know why they like Quest.
Right.
Y'all niggas didn't even know why. Because they wasn't talking that tough. You know what I'm saying? I was like, it's the low end.
I still love Who Got the Jazz and Benita Applebaum. You know what I mean? I quit smoking. That's the last thing I have since I've been here. I quit smoking.
Hey, man, that's all good, too. It's good to take a break.
Man.
I hope it's not permanent. But I did that. I take breaks.
Man, it's the longest I haven't been smoking since I was about 14.
How long you made it?
Almost 7 months, bro.
Keep going, my nigga.
7 months,
shout
bro.
Out, man. You be having weird dreams and shit.
Man, my dreams is like Inception. They like episodes
super,
of some shit.
Super clear,
super
weird
clairvoyant.
Shit.
Clairvoyant. I be like, what is the Most High trying to show me?
Yeah, bro. Yeah,
and
man.
And I used to always have like deja vu feelings before anyway. So now I should really be like, all right, what are you showing me? Shit be feeling so real.
Yeah, bro. Yeah, I get into some shit on you, man, but I'ma hold up. Alright. I'ma touch on some niggas in the news because we getting into some dialogue music. I don't wanna get lost in it. But niggas in the motherfucking news. Niggas in the motherfucking news. Okay. You fuck with Akon?
Of course. I mean, I love what he doing, man. He got the lights going out there in Africa. He buying up a lot of shit. You know what I mean? For his business mind, I don't know him personally.
Right. So you heard, you know he did a song with Tekashi.
Oh, yeah. That's all bad. I ain't fucking with that.
Okay. Then he...
Then
he said black people ain't tripping off slavery no more. You heard that?
Well, in Senegal, we've kind of overcome the thought of slavery. We don't even think about it. The only time we think about it, honestly, is when we're doing tours at Gota Island. You know, outside of that, people have lived and moved and way beyond the slavery concept and idea and mind state.
That's because they from Africa. They never been in slavery. They came and got us. Our people was enslaved, not them. You know what I mean? They know we different from them. We not I'm not going to get all into that, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
But they know we different people from them. They help capture us and bring us over here. Like, we not...
How you feel about Africans like that, them motherfuckers, man, and your relations with them?
I don't want to get all deep and spiritual, but I got a greater understanding that we not Africans, you know what I mean? We not descended from the people of Ham. We're Shemitic people, the truth, the same stuff that Nick Cannon was talking about that Viacom got on his ass about.
Yeah, I get it.
We are the true Shemitic people, bro, spread across the four corners of the earth, you know what I mean? Scattered.
Okay, I feel you.
You know what I mean? The people are the true people of the Most High. You know what I mean?
I feel you.
They do. The Africans, I mean, they... I'm not saying nothing bad about them all because they, you know, not all of us are good. You know what I mean?
But right.
That's why they look at us like that, like you American niggas, y'all lazy, y'all entitled. Like, that's why they don't really like us. A lot of Africans, man, I worked around, man, they look down on us, man. It's just something different, man. And I'm not saying that they all like that, you know what I mean?
What you think about them various religions they be practicing, like shit like the Santeria and all that type of shit?
That's like voodoo, that voodoo and,
yeah.
And, you know,
yeah.
They believe in cannibalism. You capture a warlord, kill another warlord, eat his heart. And,
yeah.
You know, they do a lot of evil, wicked shit, bro. That's all satanic occult shit, you know what I mean? Like, you know, just like... The Haitians practice voodoo.
Yeah.
And the Santa Maria in Mexico. And, like, right. it's all occult shit. The Egyptology and the Nile Valley shit that Dr. Umar Johnson preached.
Hey, you ever notice when you drive around and see the botanicas around, you know what they for, right?
What's that? Just enlighten the people, enlighten the folks.
The botanicas. That's where they get the Santa Maria supplies at.
Oh, yeah?
You never knew that? Mm-hmm. Oh, you could pull up to a botanica going
like
there
like the store,
where they got the candles and all that shit.
The
it's like
altars and shit.
Yeah, it's like magical supplies, bro. Oh, you ain't never noticed that? You see, it's right in your face. You ain't notice it,
man. You know you talking about the botanicals, yeah, like the,
so
the flower shop.
Every time, it ain't flowers in there, bro.
I flowers. They got actual.
Okay, look, you know that Santa Rita. Hey, anybody out there fuck with Santa Rita, I'm not disrespecting y'all religion.
Nah,
no curses or nothing on me.
Man, I'm protected by the Most High. That shit ain't going to work. They do it, though. They do it.
Now, look. See, one of my people put me up on that. I didn't even know he was fucking with it. He had on the beads and shit. And I'm like, man, what the fuck is them beads? He's like, oh, yeah, this is my religion, Santa Maria. And then he went into the whole thing and talked about his... His Baba Lao, like high priestess and shit. And I was like, what the fuck? What? Yeah. And then he told me about the botanicas, and I was like, and the botanicas was everywhere.
You got idols, it's like
and
idols.
Then they
and
got
shit.
The saints is on the candles, and the saint ain't what, like, it might be Saint John on the candle, but it really mean Ogun or some type of other type of shit.
A demon, they invoking evil spirits, bro.
That's what I feel like it is.
Yeah,
that's what I feel like it is. Okay. So, let me continue.
Yeah, we gonna do it, Boss Max. What you got me here for?
Let me
you gonna elaborate.
Let me continue, man. Let me pull up.
I ain't expecting a nigga from Bompton to do this. We gonna elaborate. We gonna show
him. Hey, man. Now.
That's all I'm trying to do. You know what I mean?
Hey.
Cause anybody know me know I never even went under rap. I don't care about the fame, all the extra exposure, the shit that these other niggas care about, like. I know the Most High using me for something different.
Hey, man, we gotta raise up a prophet. But you know what they say about the prophets don't get recognized by their own city. Did you read that in the Bible?
I'm knowing. Look how they did Christ. That's how they did him. I mean, he's the example.
He the one that said it too. He said a prophet don't get recognized by his own people.
Carrying the cross, they was spitting on him and whooping on him and. His own, our own people, bro. So
okay, I got another nigga in the news. All right, what you think about Kanye running for president? Keep it 100. Do we need to get the fuck out the way, or would you vote for him?
Honestly,
if he made it to where his name was on there, would you just go ahead and give him a check and say, "See, let's see what happens"?
I know all presidents; they have their agenda anyway. They just all have different personalities. That nigga crazy. I mean, he's talking some good, but that shit that you talk about Harriet Tubman, I don't agree. Kanye is just, that nigga kind of weird, man. But, of course, him being a black man, everybody naturally going to gravitate and vote for him. You know what I mean? I know whatever happened, they all got their agenda anyway. I guess I would rather see him than Hillary.
Well, Hillary ain't nowhere around, man. Hillary ain't nowhere around. I ain't gonna lie, man. I on some real shit. Oh man.
What you feel about it?
You know what? I fuck with Kamala Harris, man. I like her getting put in there. Let me tell you why I like her. Mm-hmm. And a lot of motherfuckers don't like Kamala Harris, right?
Why?
Because she, you know, okay, she, they try to say she not black. Right.
But is she?
But she black.
So they can't say
right?
that.
She from Oakland and shit.
Oh,
right?
Yeah. She,
you hear me?
Oh, yeah.
And her mama is like from India or some shit, but her pops is black and her mom's like, yeah, come on. You know what I'm saying?
They using that.
Okay, then the bitch went to Howard University.
Oh, yeah.
Right?
Intelligent. Very
now,
mysterious.
Wait. Here's the part that make me know that she a real ass bitch. Is she pledged, a.k.a. sorority, at Howard University, right? Now, y'all might know what that is, or maybe y'all don't, but that's a female sorority, mm-hmm. and that's the bitches that think they the prettiest, right? They shittiest bitches,
that's
right?
The bougie ones.
And they wear pink and green. You might have seen them out there at some frat shit, mm-hmm. a whole bunch of pink and green bitches. And then that's they, like, that Campus Howard is their alpha chapter.
Mm.
So when the sorority or fraternity start, mm-hmm. it start at one school, and that's the alpha chapter. Then it might start at another school, that's the beta chapter. And then all the way through the Greek alphabet.
Right.
So by
right.
the time it get to USC, it's Alpha Delta chapter or some type of shit, right?
Yeah.
And it got founded in 1952 or some shit. Wow, the Howard chapter got founded in 1911.
Yes,
so y'all with me?
Yes,
so that's
the
main
one.
So I'm telling y'all off the rip.
See, the people, when they get them there early, they already, okay, yeah, we can use her to run. They make their decisions back then. They pick people for that type of shit.
But see, look. See, I'm in the frat. I'm in the Q-Dog.
Man,
Omega Psi Phi
man,
Fraternity Incorporated.
I never knew that.
Okay, now look. I know all the dynamics of the frat shit, right? Mm-hmm. I done seen it.
I heard them hazes is a motherfucker.
Let me speak on that right now. AKAs get fucked up.
That's what I heard.
They get fucked up.
I'm
going to tell you, listen to me. They get fucked up more at the alpha chapter.
Cause
that's the first one. We the most gangster out of this
really
shit.
Really see what you about.
So when we travel around, ain't everybody is bowing down? Cause you know, like when they travel,
they know
they travel as a group. Just like it's the same as gang banging.
It's the same.
It's
of
very
course, of course.
Bro. That's I put that together super quick. Once I got in the frat, I was like, oh shit, this is gang
it's
banging.
Shit. I mean,
this is gang banging. We ain't killing motherfuckers.
It's per se.
Not like
far as on no tribal shit like
on
gangs
no
is
excessive,
like
you
on
know
site
what I'm saying,
type
random
shit, like
type shit.
Is,
but we got beef with each other.
It's a secret society.
We got a lot of beef
yeah.
with each other. Okay,
it's
now
animosity for sure.
So the bitches is getting fucked up, and if you come from West Coast and go back that way,
really
you get fucked
me.
Up some more.
Damn.
So I know she a real ass bitch from that.
Just that alone.
Just that.
Mm-hmm.
Then she came out of there and started fucking with a politician out here, a gangster politician named Willie Brown. Y'all may have heard that name before. He was a super slick type of dude.
Who's he from?
He was up in Northern California. He was the mayor of San Francisco.
Yeah.
But if you ever Google this motherfucker and see a picture of him, He looked like a pimp.
Straight from the project.
He looked like a player, right? Yo, he looked like a player. He was like 60 years old, and she was 30. And
oh,
he was fucking with her,
oh, yeah,
right?
He's a bad.
And he was fucking with her. And she was a bad bitch, though, dude. Look.
He got her.
And then after that, she started blowing up. She moved up through the DA's department, all kinds of shit.
Tapped in with him, and he opened up some doors for her.
So a lot of motherfuckers want to hate on the bitch for that. I was like, yo, man, that's seasoning.
Man. She got game.
She got that.
To be able to know. And now her husband is white. And motherfuckers want to say, ah, she fuck with a white man. I was like, nah, she fucking with a safe man. She got a nigga that ain't going to give her no fucking problems while she go do this mission. Because if she fuck with a nigga, he going to be.
He going to stress her
he
the
gonna
fuck
out. She going to be distracted.
Man, for real.
Anyway, so. And then here's another thing. I observed the bitch. Mm-hmm. You know, it done been like the Senate done pressed different motherfuckers for different shit that they did. Mm. So like Donald Trump, when he put Sessions as the Attorney General.
Yeah.
Right? When he first came into office.
Mm-hmm.
And then Sessions was like, when they was like, Donald, we finna come after you for we believe you treason. And then Sessions said, hey, I can't be involved in this shit, and recused himself. Uh-huh. And then Senate was like, hey man, what the fuck going on? We need to holler. What the fuck y'all motherfuckers doing? What's popping? So then Kamala had him in there on the press like, hey. So what and they was folding up. She was folding these motherfuckers up. She folded up three potent white motherfuckers.
Off in the Senate, huh?
That bitch folded up three white motherfuckers, man.
She know her shit.
She know her shit. So I kind of, and she seems sincere when you look in a bitch's eyes. Because you know we got to, you know, at the end of the day, it kind of come down to that. Because we got the 4K. And I be in the shit, the high definition. You feel me? So I be looking up. Man, look here, man. I be looking at motherfuckers' eyes trying to see motherfuckers' eyes. And certain motherfuckers, you can't see their eyes. And they looking straight at the motherfucking camera. And his eyes look like a beady. You can't see shit. You just see like, damn, what is that motherfucker? But you can see her eyes, though. You can see her eyes. Let me see. That mic kind of hit the mic. They come in. Mic checks that. Yeah. It got like a little. Hold on, let me see.
Here we go. That sound a lot better. Yeah. Man, that shit smell good, boy. Y'all making me want to relapse.
Man, fight the power, bro. Fight the power, man.
That's one thing, man. You know, another thing, I'm a vegan now, Boss Matt.
Mm-hmm.
No meat.
Mm-hmm. You know,
Dr. Sabi,
you know I've been paying attention to all that shit you've been doing. I seen vegan in it. Yeah.
That shit helped me with a lot of discipline.
I feel you, man.
A lot of discipline and shit too, man.
I feel you, man. I you know, I used to do the vegan shit back in the day when Boogie Down KRS-One came out.
Yeah.
I just turned vegan because he came out. He influenced me. Like how the niggas get influenced by lean, he influenced me to go vegan. I'm going vegan. Like how niggas fuck. I'm going with lean, nigga.
Man, right.
I ain't gonna lie. Okay. Hey, man, I ain't gonna lie. I'm gonna keep it 100, man. Let me that motherfucker do that again. Say something.
Hey man, I appreciate you having me here, man. For real, man. I know you probably thought this nigga not gonna show up. This nigga Picasso not coming.
Hey man, niggas made it. It's all good. I just uploaded a show like today and shit. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah, so you working, like, bro. You working.
I was like, no matter what, it's all good. We're going to get it done.
Okay, for sure, for sure.
Okay, you fuck with another nigga in the news. You fuck with Jam Master Jay? You heard about that?
Jam, that nigga's a legend. They said Jam Master Jay was a gangster for real from Queens. He got run and all them niggas on the wearing Adidas and them niggas are squares. Jay was a real nigga from Jamaica.
Do you
from
know
Hollis.
Why?
Hollis.
Do you know why he got killed though?
I don't know the details.
They found the killers.
Yeah, what was they reasoning? I heard it was one of their old partners and shit came in the studio and all of that type of shit. What was the reason behind it, man? Some fuck shit.
Jam Master Jay was flipping chickens, bro.
I can imagine.
He was flipping chickens.
It don't surprise me.
The niggas was felt like they got into it, and the niggas felt like he owed them.
Owed them for me, like, nigga,
some
you
niggas, some niggas took an L, and he was hot, and they was hot, and they, yeah.
Yeah.
I had no concept that he was a, I had no idea.
Man,
that
I could tell, bro.
Absolute, I thought it was some music shit, like, I'm mad at you, you didn't produce my shit or some shit.
Nah.
Yeah, I
seen the picture. Y'all went to New York. You know what I'm saying? Bro. Big Jake, rest in peace
and all that. Man,
like,
nigga.
So y'all know it's real niggas everywhere, bro. Yeah. Like, niggas think niggas just make music. And I guess it was a good disguise, him being Rud DMC, the DJ. That nigga was flipping chickens
the whole time. He probably was flipping them the whole time.
Scratching records, you know what I'm saying? Like, my Adidas, I got a 30-piece in the back.
Man, I remember when back in the days, you know, during our musical journey, man, when we was coming up, you know, it was used to be Uncle Jam's Army and all that type of shit. They used to be throwing parties at the L.A. Sports Arena and shit.
Wow.
Back when 6-0 used to come up there and beat up the whole motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? But before they tore the shit up, you know, you could see some historical type shit, bro. So motherfucker like Run DMC had first came out.
They came there?
Yeah. And performed. And we knew who they was. And motherfuckers really wasn't fucking with them like that.
Tune.
But we was on they dick, bro. We stood in front of the stage. we was on Jam Master J dick so hard. Me, LG, and the homie N-Walk. Nigga, we stood at the front of the stage and watched niggas set up his equipment. Studied. Okay, he hooked it up like that. He did this. Okay, he's doing
real,
that. Nigga,
real.
Niggas might as well had our notepad going.
Mental,
every motherfucking thing
notes,
he did.
Okay, damn
he did this, he did that. Okay, yeah.
Damn
okay.
Right.
When he was scratching, you see how his hands was? Yeah.
Before Google and all that shit, you had to study some shit.
Niggas was at home practicing that shit that night. Niggas at home like, yeah, this is how he was. Yeah. He had the 1200s, man. You know, we got to get him.
1200s.
1200s. We got to, okay, we got everything he did.
Man, for real,
we
bro.
Studying them niggas, man. But it was, we saw them niggas come through this motherfucker.
That's like a hell of an experience, bro.
It was cool,
I heard
man.
The Dudos used to be like that, too. The skating ring,
my
man.
My nigga.
A bunch of niggas used to come through. My nigga. LL Cool J. Like,
my nigga.
All type of heads,
my
man.
My nigga. I'm just going to speak.
I was a baby.
I'm just gonna speak on the new edition coming through Dudo. Wow.
See, niggas
now you need to tap into that. That's some Michael. That's some Jackson 5 type
monumental
shit
type shit
coming through the hood
in
when
the
they
hood
was at maximum hot.
And for y'all don't know where the Dudo's at, that's
nigga,
right off
nigga.
Central, nigga, right by Paru Street.
Nigga,
that's right in Compton, nigga.
Nigga.
I mean, right by Paru Street.
About every nigga who thought he was a player, every nigga who thought he had bitches, every nigga who thought he was the nigga got forgot.
It's over.
When them niggas came in there,
that's type of shit you can't bitches, bring your girl to. Don't
bitches
bring your girl
went
to.
Bitches went into the trance. They went into the pass out shake. They went into the nigga touch a bitch, bitch piss. Collapse. They gotta get her. Bro, and I have seen
bro
the hysteria type shit up close.
multiple times.
That shit is like a Holy Ghost.
Them niggas, man. Hey, Dudos was some special shit. And that was just when that happened, that was some special shit right there. Mm-hmm. But yeah, and then like, but you know, on our New York trip, bro, mm-hmm. that right there, my nigga, the New York shit. Let me describe how epic that was. First of all, niggas is flying on scam tickets. Hotel room on scam credit cards.
Niggas is getting it in back then.
Niggas got the niggas had like
hey, it's nothing niggas new had under the sun. Like
niggas had multiple vans. We had multiple vans out there moving around, nigga. Soon as we listen.
Who y'all listen, tapped in with out there?
Listen, nigga.
Yes, sir.
As soon as we landed at Kennedy, got in the van, stepped outside freezing cold.
Man.
Niggas drove into Harlem. You understand what I'm talking about? Soon as we drove in, Gangstar is shooting a video.
Hell no.
Nigga, we just pulled up. Listen. We just pulled up on they shit and got out and started passing out our cassettes. And niggas was like, Compton's Righteous? What the fuck?
Right.
New York niggas is arrogant. And then they number one G homie just became our tour guide, like right on the spot. Immediately embraced us. I got y'all for this whole thing. Immediately tap in.
Shout out to my Harlem niggas, man. Shout out to my nigga. Listen,
my nigga, we wasn't there 2 hours. And we was already politicking heavily.
Off top. You know how we get down?
Niggas embraced, nigga. We was out that night at the nigga in free at the most popping venue that night. Right now, nigga.
I'm still in awe about that. Just the premiere and Ghoul, they right there. Y'all see that? Oh yeah.
Like, Taking Loot. The video was for Taking Loot. If y'all ever see that video for Taking Loot.
Niggas is there and live in effect.
Politic with them right now. Right now, nigga.
Rest in peace, Guru, man.
Right now, nigga. I was just like, damn, it was.
See, that's why I rap the way I rap, because I'm a fan of that type of shit. When and I don't even want to rap, them was the niggas I looked up to.
And then the next morning, we pulled up on Source Magazine. Now, this was before. This is before motherfuckers knew that they needed security and shit in the lobby and all that type of shit, right? So you feel me? Look, this was how we got popping. This was one of my methods because, you know, I put together the marketing plan, what we was doing. I was like, okay, we just going to pay Source for a full page cover ad. And back then it was like 4 racks or something
that. Was
like
in the
that.
Source. Compton Righteous was in the Source.
Bro,
I'm sorry.
Hold up, man. Let me finish talking. We did it. Okay, we got our shit reviewed in the Source where Dre got the gun to his cover where he got the gun to his head.
Mm-hmm.
We got reviewed in that Source magazine. That was with the Chronic, Bizarre Ride to the Far Side album, and it was somebody else's album.
Wow.
But look, our ad appeared in that magazine right there, right?
It's dope,
so
bro.
Then that put us on a national level.
Scale, hell yeah. Right? Definitely.
And we had videos at BET. And so we was on The Box and we was on Rap City.
Wow.
We had got videos.
We had got
2 videos shot for like 10 racks back in the day, which was some unheard of, unreal shit. Big Will had to connect.
Yeah.
And he was our manager too.
Shout out to Big Homie Will, man.
If you didn't know, he was our manager too. So then
we paid, like I said, paid Source that, right? Mm-hmm. So as soon as we paid them that, I knew we could press them for the review. Y'all got to review our shit and give us some mics.
Top. Hell yeah. You feel me? At least give us something.
So look.
We were just talking about the fire mics.
They didn't know
days ago.
They didn't know we was coming out there. You understand me?
Mm-hmm.
We did all that from the hood. I was running a record label out of my mom's apartment in the hood.
Man.
In the front right there.
Top,
upstairs from me, man. We mashed on the Source the next morning. They didn't know he was coming. He was like, "Hey man, what's up, man? We up here to see our review. What? How many mics did we get?" "Oh man, it ain't out yet. We didn't do it yet. Y'all didn't do it yet. Now we deep. We deep. We probably like." We probably like 10 niggas, right? So we got different characters with us though. We got different characters. So you see Jake is like
top. That's
Jake
enough.
Like
he
that.
Like
so
five
you,
niggas
so
himself.
So you focusing on Jake, but then it's niggas like Jim Bob, and you know how Jim Bob is like he kind of vanished and shit. So Jim Bob vanished into their office, right? So they talking to me and another nigga, and they lying, talking about, "Hey man, we ain't do the review. The review ain't out yet. The review ain't out yet."
Yeah, bullshit. Yeah.
That nigga Jim Bob.
When found one of the magazines.
That nigga Jim Bob came from a back room, like, "Yo, I got the magazine right here, blood. I got it right here." Oh man, blood. They gave us three mics.
Three mics.
But look, Bizarre Ride to the Far Side got 3.5 mics.
You can at least get
niggas
3.5.
Like 3.5. Man, but look, the chronic got 4.5. We was like, how's that not a classic? How's that not 5 mics?
Right, off top.
What the fuck?
Top. Y'all they biased, though. You know they was biased back
then. Bro, what is y'all talking, bro? How is this, bro?
It was L.A.-based, Compton-based, West Coast shit, you know.
The Chronic, we was in there like, we already pissed about our shit. You feel me? But we like, the Chronic is 5 mics, my
fire.
Nigga. Come on, nigga. The Chronic had just dropped.
That shit is
undeniable. We was out there driving around off the Chronic, nigga. We was out
hell
there just that whole trip was every cut off the Chronic. That's the soundtrack.
That's how I used to be.
That's the soundtrack to that
that's
trip.
That's how I used to be.
While we was in New York.
Played a whole tape.
In New York.
You played a whole tape.
But anyway, that's about New York. Then we did a show out there too. Like,
yeah.
We did a show like in a club. It was called The Muse. And they was like,
was that?
It was some underground New York shit, nigga.
Tunnel type
real
shit.
Yeah, nigga, for real, nigga. Bullet holes shot up. The shit shot the wall. Bullet shit shot up. We just in that motherfucker.
Yeah.
And I remember the motherfuckers was like, "Damn, man. You know, this is a pretty, you know, pretty tough crowd. I only seen KRS-One rocking here, and Redman, and Tribe Called Quest. Everybody else pretty much got booed, it's a tough. It's hey man, I'm just letting you know. I know y'all out here from Compton. You feel me? Nigga, we went in there, did our shit, and they, you know, they wasn't jumping around lit. But they didn't boo us. They fucked with us. And motherfuckers was like, "Hey, y'all niggas is tight. They listen to y'all and listen to..." Nigga, y'all niggas is lucky, nigga. It was hard to process that type of shit. And I just was really tapped into the whole experience of being out there.
Yeah, man.
Just vibing and shit, driving around, buying they weed. Going, driving through they.
How was the weed? I know that shit was trash.
Yeah, man,
yeah, diesel.
It was weird, man. They weed at the time was kind of weird because it was dirt weed, but for some kind of reason, they had Philly blunts at that time.
Hmm.
And for some reason, the Phillies in New York was different than the Phillies out here. Like, they was more moist or some type of shit out there.
Right.
I don't know what the fuck. They was fresher. Mm-hmm. So it went with the weed better. They tried. They shitty weed went with the Philly better out there than, you know what I'm saying? It was a weird ass shit.
It balanced out.
It was some weird shit. But it was a good experience, you know. They shit never closed. It was always
them bodegas and all those type of shit.
Shit was active all night, continuous, man.
Shout out to my New York niggas, man. My experience. New York Nellies and all that, man. I'ma tap in.
Yeah, and it was no Bloods in New York when we went. We was the first niggas. We was the first Bompton niggas to. T-Tone had on the Bompton hat. He the first nigga that had Bompton material out there in New York.
Man, off top, I believe it.
You know what I'm saying?
They had their own indigenous gangs out there, Decepticons, the Lowlifes, and all of
that
shit.
They all on some serious gangbang shit. Yeah, how you feel about that shit?
Man, a lot of homies from out that way be tapping in with me, man, from Jersey and New York.
They be reaching out to a nigga, huh?
A couple of them just left. A homie from CT, homie from Jersey and shit. And they asked me how I feel about it, you know what I mean? Like, I'm like, you know, honestly, it's kind of weird to me because I know y'all got your own shit that y'all do out there. But
yeah.
I respect a nigga that gravitate towards the hood. And if you a solid individual, you pushing it, I can't help but respect that. You know what I mean? Like, because it's real niggas everywhere. It's fake niggas everywhere. It's snitches. It's the same elements of the streets everywhere. You know what
right. You know, niggas is killers out there. I know ain't no bitch ass niggas, but I just be tripping off of how the influence went
the
that way. Like,
you know what I mean? Like,
the influence.
Me too. I'll be like, how y'all Nellas is, man, and how y'all Nellas in Connecticut? How y'all Nellas in Cincinnati and South Carolina? This nigga's everywhere from Campanella.
It's like, motherfucker, you can't even really tap into the true reason why it was that from the gate. It's a reason why it began from the gate. It began because of a certain reason, and those conditions don't exist where you are.
For sure.
You could have banged your own shit. You could have been out there and been like,
a lot of them,
we having this type of issue out here. Let's call our shit this. You know,
that's just like us in California trying to be gangster disciples or black disciples or vice lords or something.
Right.
That's the Midwest shit. Like, I feel the same way. Like, you know me. Like, you know me.
Right.
My mom's and my pop's from the hood. Like,
right.
I couldn't help it. Right. I was a Nella baby for real. If my pops was a foreman, I would have did that. If my mom's was a nurse or something, I would have took after the trade. What we did.
I feel you. Hey, bro.
Ain't nothing I wanted to do for real. I was really born in this shit.
I'm always fascinated by the hood because, see, I moved to the hood as a youth. You understand me? Like, you know, at the age of 8 years old to Nella, and many, many years ago, like 1976. You understand me? In the times when niggas like Big Tookie and them motherfuckers was over there and used to come up to the pool, because you know all the come up to the pool. You know, the pool was lit. I heard.
The park has always been
here,
a story.
And look, here, and this is some, this is what I try to articulate to motherfuckers as an 8-year-old motherfucker coming from Milwaukee, Wisconsin. 8 years old. Came out here, staying with my G-mom. My grandmoms was living in apartments. A nigga went outside to the park, right? Day one, and became aware. Listen, and became aware that I could die out here. And my grandmother has no understanding. She don't have no understanding.
What a youth got to do?
What's
deal
out
with.
Here
they
in
don't.
This motherfucking park?
The parents and the grandparents, they don't, man. Every day, man, you can die for
you
real,
bro. At 8 years old, I was like, wait a minute.
They don't know, man.
This is way more dangerous than Milwaukee, where
treacherous.
I came from. Back then, dude, I was acutely aware of that.
Most definitely.
Acutely aware of that shit.
Immediately.
Man. Like, man, I knew that shit.
You feel the tension, bro. Like, it's different.
It's
and no disrespect to my women, but y'all don't know. Especially being a young black male out here, like, Y'all better talk to y'all sons every night, man. Ask them how their day was going, man.
Niggas do not.
Every day.
No.
Y'all don't know. Just because they making home, that don't mean that was a blessing. Every day is a journey. That shit is a battle, bro. It start from kids. Especially back then, banging was real. Like, it'd be grown niggas that hop out and want to beat you up and shoot you. And you can just try to be a normal. Like me, I my best friends was in the anime and video games and shit. I tried to be normal as I could, but just niggas knowing, oh, you little Vibo son. And I'm looking like my pops and I'm wearing red and shit. Like, you know what I mean? Because that's just what we do. I'm not really knowing, but I'm still trying to be normal. But you can't be normal. It's the circumstances we're from.
Ain't no normal.
It's not normal about it. It's very abnormal.
It's some tribal-ass shit that go long distance.
Man.
You know what I'm saying?
Especially you in the midst of it, you're going to deal with the shit, bro. Like, I commend the sisters that take y'all kids and see that shit and move them somewhere else. Fuck on.
But it's fascinating to see that infect the world, though. Like,
right,
because
right.
I knew it was infectious when I seen it. So it's a trip to know that I'm not tripping. Like,
I think Colors had a lot to do with that. That movie Colors came
Colors,
out.
Colors, yeah. Yeah, Colors.
And then, like, niggas, you know, spreading out, you know what I mean? Niggas from out here, like Melvin and all them, and try to sell dope and set up shop in different states and shit. They start having niggas being Crips and Bloods. And
Colors, I'm going to say this, bro. When we went to New York, and the way I seen them niggas embrace us, them niggas like just really like on a serious level, like just really embraced us, like, like, you know what I'm saying? And Jake now, man, Jake was a different kind of motherfucker, man. Like,
that's a piece of big homie.
You know, a lot of motherfuckers, you can't even really.
Yeah, my name is Jake, you know what I'm saying? I'm from Westside, Campanella Park, Piru, you know. Been, you know, doing this here type of lifestyle since I was about 13 years old, you know, and been through the penitentiary systems, all the little juvenile system, 5 years, 6 years in the state, you know, and I'm just gonna kick a little something. Everybody wanna know why people bang, why people kill, why people do this, sell dope, and you can't just look at the individuals, because, you know, you have to look at the environment that they're set in that creates these conditions for them to have to live and do the things that they do. And so we just kicking it like that. You know, we ain't out here S'ing on our chest, but you know, it's like everybody out here wanna be a tough guy, killer, a gangster, you understand? But most of the killers and gangsters I know either got all day or dead. So everybody out here just living. So, you know, we kicking it from that perspective.
You know what I'm
saying? For me, it wasn't like no peer pressure thing. You know why? I'm just jumping on the bandwagon. I'ma do this because all the homeboys doing it. My thing is, like, you know, growing up in a certain neighborhood, you have altercations with people that grew up on another part of a certain neighborhood, and you grow up, and you know, it's affiliation through association. And then coming up with that, you know what I'm saying, my mama just happened to have her house on the side where the red team was at. So there it is right there. And in doing that, you know, you growing up, doing everything out in the streets, from murder, money, violence, to sex, and the out of town, going out of town with the doing your work and all of this, that's all been done, you know what I'm saying? It's 94, you gotta have a new twist with things. You know, I did a year juvenile, you know what I'm saying? 4.5 years in the state penitentiary. You know, I done been to damn near all of them, folks from Quentin, Soledad, you know, Jamestown, Solano, Vacaville, you know, on tour. So as far as like all the negatives I've seen, now, in my life at this point, I'm making a transition to do positive things and to, you know, try to alleviate a lot of the bullshit that's going on out here with the streets with these youngsters that ain't knowing. You know, they don't know that these white folks got a place for them for the rest of their life. They might not never even see their neighbor and be in a penitentiary 5-10 years and never even see the person next to them in the next cell because they got places for them with these drive-bys, automatic weapons. everything that's going on out here, the dope, you know. They want to give us all day for catching 2 or 3 ounces hard. And you know what I'm saying? They catch John DeLorean with 100 keys and a camera, give him a smack on the hand so you see what's going on. So you got the, you know what I mean, peep game and just, you know, stay above water. You know what I'm saying? And with the Crips and the Bloods and this truce and all this, you know, I didn't participate with the truce because I didn't feel like it was being put down right. You know what I'm saying? I don't need to be drinking and hanging out with you to kick it with you. You understand? You stay in your neighborhood, keep your people organized, deal with your people. I stay in my neighborhood, deal with my people, keep them organized. When you see me, give me a pass. When I see you, I give you a pass. But all this old week on hang out and all that, I still think, you know, we need to go through some more steps and levels before we get to that point. Because I don't think everybody be sincere about, you know what I'm saying, putting this gang thing behind us. And I know a lot of people been killed behind it, a lot of lives been taken, you know what I'm saying? But my thing be like this. People want to be gangsters, they want to put work in, want to do this, but you can go around the corner and just shoot up 3 or 4 black men. The sheriffs get behind you. You got 2 AKs in the car, 4 Tech 9s, you know what I'm saying? 10 pistols, and they tell you to freeze your stop. You understand? They only 2 individuals with 2 guns. You done went shot 4 or 5 blacks up, but you freeze when they tell you. I'm saying if you're a gangster, sell the ranch, grandma, grandpa, the chickens, everything. If you're going out with bullets and gun smoke, don't just stop with yours. You understand me? Deal with it on that level if that's what you're doing. If you're not, get out the way. Let somebody else that is. Quit perpetrating.
And we do a thing. It's called respect. You know what I'm saying? We don't be getting caught out of pocket in another nigga neighborhood.
One of a kind, for real, man.
I mean, like, cause you know, I knew Jake before he went to prison. So I seen the pre-prison Jake, right? And I knew his makeup. I knew everybody's DNA. We knew that Jake had some like Black Panther type shit going
Revolutionary.
On in his background. We knew his moms and them was affiliated type shit. So he was kind of like predestined for some shit like that. So when he started banging and got caught up in the shit, I think he got shot early. And he did some super retaliation type shit. But when he went to the pen,
he seen what was really going on as far as the infrastructure and just how it's really racial in there. And then, you know, you're going to be in there with Crips. You know what I mean? Like, niggas be beefing on the streets, but when you go in there, like, it's racial. So you got to, it's like a black thing. I think
in the county.
I think
he might have hit an Aryan Nation motherfucker in the county. I think. I'm not 100% sure. But I think he saw him reading some material.
He just knew
that he needed to do something to him and he hit him. Mm-hmm. And then he got somebody in the, I think it might have been a BGF motherfucker, Black Gorilla Family motherfucker, mm-hmm. wrote him a letter in like Swahili or some shit and gave it to him. And he went, and when he got sent to another yard, he gave the nigga a letter. And then he was just on connected. After that. So this nigga respect level. So you gotta understand, you know, I'm interpreting niggas. You know, because I went to college, and then I came back. It's like I went to college and,
yes, sir.
And just came back to do my graduate work in the hood and shit, like graduate degree in hood shit. So I'm back in the hood. Jake back out the pen, right?
Time.
So this is how we all connecting.
Yes, sir.
And so I'm seeing how everybody get down. So Big Two.
Man, you was around, bro.
I know all, you know
around,
what I'm saying?
Bro.
I'm seeing
around.
How niggas is moving, right?
He was the real Nella BC,
but,
man.
But Jake is like
different.
He commanded more. Like, he got more motherfuckers fucking with him from other places. Yeah, exactly. That's the first time I had really seen niggas do that. That was the first time I seen niggas just be a politician like that.
Yes, indeed.
Yeah. I was like, man, this nigga. Political skills is on a high echelon.
Very intelligent, man. Like,
but I, you know, I.
You want to talk about how Jake got that Death Row shit going? Niggas know Jake, the one hooked Harry O up with Suge. I know you was around, you know what I'm saying? Like, we don't want to get too deep, but.
Well, I mean, you know.
I'm proud that's my big homie, bro. That's why I rep this, man.
Hey, bro.
I don't want to get too deep, but that's why I got Nella love, man. Like, I'm trying to just keep that going, you know what I'm saying? The intelligence and just the revolutionary shit, just.
I feel you, bro.
I'm proud. That make me proud, bro.
Hey, man.
That's why I don't care about none of them industry niggas. They weird to me, bro. Like, I grew up around solid niggas, man. My big homies is them niggas for real to me. You know what I mean? Real OGs. Like I said, you've been around in that area, bro. You know what I mean? Like, utmost respect for you.
I be trying to tell niggas. I be like,
we really do this shit where I'm from, bro.
Hey, I be telling
historical shit.
I be telling niggas like,
I don't do all that talking, man. Niggas know what's up with me, bro. Like,
you know, like, you know, I go hard on niggas, man, on my own homies.
You know
what I'm saying? I go hard on my own homies. I talk shit about them, whatever. But at the end of the day, long time ago, I stepped back and was like, a lot of my niggas is like great. You understand me? Like,
Huey P. Newton, like on a national type of level.
Like certain activities the niggas did. I haven't heard no other niggas did that.
Can't be emulated, bro. Can't be.
Multiple niggas. From multiple niggas that did shit to where it was like, I haven't really seen no other niggas do that.
It came, man.
So I have to put our shit up like at a high level.
It deserves it.
At like a high level. It deserves it, bro. Even in other states and shit, I look at different shit. I be like, man, our shit is at like a high level to be respected.
This shit different than the Roy for real, man. No disrespect to nobody else, no other hood or nothing, man, but just. Y'all can just do y'all. Ask y'all big homies. They'll tell you. You know what I'm saying? If they ain't a
that
hater,
it's crazy, man.
This is real shit, bro.
Yeah, man. All right, I don't want to go too deep into this. Okay, that's good shit. Fans don't want to hear that. They want to know how to put bitches on the team and shit. Okay,
ask me some questions about me. We can talk about me. You know
okay,
what I'm
now,
rap shit.
Now
I'm a rapper. We just rap.
Okay, now. You fuck with Conway and Westside Gunn, right?
Man, I love their music, bro. I fuck with that shit. Hell, you know that. Benny the Butcher, you know what I mean? My boy Jay Worthy, man. Shout out Jay Worthy. He was on tour with him. You know what I mean? On his first tour, he went with them niggas. Like,
hey, your boy Jay Worthy. That nigga called me, bro. He
told me he's gonna ask you for the beach. You know what I'm saying? We thinking about doing some shit. He said he was gonna hit you.
I'm like,
call the big homie, get the blessings.
I've been wanting to talk to that nigga for so long. It was cool.
He was listening to that shit. He like, man, that shit is so dope. He like, man, try to ask Boss Mac if we can use it. And I'm like, shit, call that nigga, man. It's the big homie.
Hell
like,
yeah, man. Y'all niggas can use them beats. That nigga LG got the beats though on his shit and in his samplers though, man. I don't know if he could recreate, if he could pull it back up, but I know he got them still in his primitive. He got a primitive sampler over there from back.
Primitive.
You know what I'm saying? It still work like a motherfucker.
That's the best shit.
You know, a lot of dudes like Madlib and motherfuckers like that, they still use all the old equipment to create the sound.
That shit worked the best, bro.
And they still, you know what I'm saying?
Top.
Now I'm gonna tell you, man. My nigga,
you know Madlib?
I don't know Madlib.
I'm about to say, if you know to tell that nigga,
Madlib. Madlib is weird. I don't know him.
I heard he like a monk or something. He only come
he
off
don't
the
fuck
mountain.
With nobody.
Every
he
once
don't
in
fuck
a while.
With nobody. Niggas.
I
niggas
love to get a beat.
But I'm gonna tell you, man. I'm gonna keep it 100, man. And I
you know, I'm gonna go ahead and do it in this podcast format. I was gonna do it off the podcast format. I'm gonna do it on here, man. I think you could. Do you know LG son Reap? You know him?
Nah.
You don't know him. Jarrell.
I might have seen him. You know what I'm saying?
He used to live in apartments a long time ago.
That name sounds kind of familiar, though. He dope, too, though. He dope on he make beats and shit.
His father made the Compton's Righteous beat.
LG, that's his father, right?
That's his father, right? So, he copying him. You know what I'm saying? So he make them kind of beat.
Yeah. But you got to plug us up, man. Tap us in.
Yeah, I'm about to plug y'all up, man.
Off top, man.
Because it's a weird thing, man, because I was telling G-Weed about him right before G-Weed got caught up in the shit. And I was like, Weed, why aren't you fucking with Rail? And he was like, what? I'm like, he got beats. He's like, well, shit, I don't know. He doing all type of shit. I can't.
You know, everybody don't want to fuck with that type of shit, man. You know.
I'm a hip hop man. Free G Weed. That's my big homie.
Yeah.
Free G Weed. Bad just came home. You know what I'm saying? Bad at home.
That's where I'm different at. That's my lane. I figured my lane out. All the old school, the lyrical shit, all that type of melodic sample shit. That's all I want to fuck with. You know what I mean? But I still do something with anybody else, you know what I mean? It'll make me be more versatile. It's not like that's just my preference, you know what I mean? Because that's the era I grew up in, you know what I mean? So, I fuck with that shit all day, bro.
Yeah, I'm going to plug you with old boy and see if y'all could get something popping, man. Yeah, because we vibing off of your shit. But all right, have you noticed they shows, Conway and them shows?
That shit be lit, bro. The first one, they brought out everybody. They had Wu-Tang there. Yeah, Styles P. Like, all the greats. I think Prodigy before he died. Rest in peace, Prodigy. Like, they was all in the building. You know what I mean? And, you know, Conway, he did that one song. I think it's called, I forgot what that shit called. We talk about when he got shot in the head and his boy Machine Gun and all that. He then cried on stage and shit. Like, That shit was, man, that shit was epic.
Them niggas don't be having bitches at they show. You understand me? Bro, I don't like that, man. Like, I'm cool with you know, I'm with it.
Them niggas too hard. They too hard.
Come on, man.
They too hard, man. They too, like you said earlier, we talking about the beat selection. It's too grimy. They not making nothing for the women, bro. They don't give a fuck. They just.
And I'm going to tell you why I like their first video.
Which one? Is it Conway or is it West Side Gun?
It was West Side Gun. I forgot the name. 95, 100.
I like Gun, man.
I forgot
what
it was.
Creative,
it was some shit. It was a weird name, but I checked it out because they was on the Joe Budden podcast and they boy Maul had spoke about it. And I was like, let's check these niggas out. And the reason why I liked it is because they had a bitch carrying some off-white, off-white bag, bringing him some money. That made me like it. See, I was like, okay, see, that's what I'm talking about.
Right.
He know what to do. Mm-hmm. I ain't seen no more videos like that from him since. It's just been niggas standing around.
I be fucking with some niggas,
mad.
Man.
And to me, them visuals is cool. See, I'm going to start doing videos for me. I'm going to start directing videos,
yeah.
Man. If this corona shit wouldn't have happened, kind of slowed me down
a little
bit.
For sure you can direct one of my joints, man.
Because I believe niggas got to give the appropriate stimuluses in the video. You can't just have one-dimension stimulus.
Yeah.
Like niggas. Nah, or niggas
gotta
and guns.
Have replay value.
You got to have bitches in there. You got to have... I gotta know that bitches fuck with you.
Not necessarily they twerking and all that other shit.
They ain't just twerk.
But some artistic.
They just gotta be.
You gotta
in
implement
there.
Implement them.
You know what I'm saying?
Incorporate the women.
She set a beverage in front of you and left.
Yeah.
See, I know you fuck with bitches.
Be some player shit.
See,
off top.
You understand what I mean? Like,
she came with a sandwich on a platter.
Wait, gave it to you. Bro.
She rubbing your back or something while you rapping.
Hey, man, that's why I liked Rick Ross over 2 Chainz. When I saw the bitch massaging him, I was like, oh, my God, 2 Chainz lost. As soon as I saw that,
yeah,
I didn't even hear shit.
That's why I fuck a Rosé, too. That nigga cold. He be in the mansion somewhere. He got a woman feeding him grapes and bringing him a plate of grapes.
Bro.
She just in the hot tub in the pool just jumping out with 2 pieces.
I told niggas.
Fat boy cold.
I told niggas when Biggie... The moment Biggie sold me when he was in the bed. Who the hell is this? Put me in 2 cocks in the mold with the 2 bitches in the bed. And then push one bitch off with crotch dome.
All right, then there's Crusher.
Crusher got out the way like the bitch didn't count. 2 bitches. This ugly motherfucker.
Man, Big Pun,
I fuck
too.
With this.
Big Pun, too. Rest in peace, Big Pun. I'm not a player, but I crush a lot.
I told niggas, man, I got niggas got to let me direct their video so I can get niggas right, bro. Like,
dude, everybody not gonna do it. They can't. They don't need that seasoning.
Right. There's a couple of niggas that I believe in. Hey, yo. I think. You know what I'm saying, bro. I'm telling you, my nigga. I'm telling you, you had that visual right there, my nigga.
Man.
You going to have some successes. Remember what I'm talking about. I fuck with Fat Meats. You know about Fat Meats?
Fat Meats.
You ever heard of him? Fat Meats. He kind of like on some Rod Wave type of shit.
Okay.
But he don't sing like heartbroke songs. He sing like, I'm going to kill you. You robbed me. You was my homie, but you ran a twist on me. I'm going to fucking pop you when I see
you. I'll find
you. That type shit.
Your days is numbered.
But I told him, I was like, man, you got to let me do your visuals, man. He having relationships with his girlfriend on the page. I'm like, dude, don't nobody want to see that. Niggas want to see you with some bitches. Different. Niggas want to see you with some differences.
Some player shit.
You know
man.
What I mean? And they'll believe in the big fat dude that's fly. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, man. But let me... Hey, we gonna have to talk.
Man, we gonna lock in for sure, for sure. You know that, big dog.
All right, now.
For sure.
Man, I gotta do some reader listener email, man. Niggas gonna get mad at me, man. You mind if I do one, man? I'm gonna do one.
Let's do it.
And then you know what I'm saying. I'm gonna come back and talk to you some more, man. So I gotta at least put something in there.
Yeah, let's do it, man.
Hour into it. All right. Reader listener email. Now I got a couple, but I'm gonna just do one right quick. All right. A nigga from Los Angeles writes to Boss Mac. He say, Boss Mac, I'm working with a new bitch on the team. I'm trying to get her to cooperate. She's married, but she's about to get a divorce, but she don't live with her husband no more. She was cool until she started getting upset with my relationship with my stepdaughter. My ex bitch was pregnant when I got with her. And the baby father didn't give a fuck, so I stepped up, and me and my ex-bitch broke up, but I still kept up the baby daddy duties. Wow. Now my new bitch be tripping every time I say my stepdaughter's name. As a matter of fact, she just did a girl's trip and haven't hit me since she came back in a week. Boss Mac, how do I tighten up my game on this bitch?
So he needs some consultation. He got a lot going on.
Okay, so he's saving a daughter.
Still
so,
trying to be stepdaddy
so
to his ex girl.
You being a dad to your ex bitch
daughter.
Daughter.
A whole nother nigga.
And, you know, I commend that as honorable in the world. You know what I'm saying?
I've tried to do shit like
you,
that.
You deserve a star for that. You know what I'm saying? God will remember that you was doing that.
Yeah, he cared, but
you know what I'm saying?
That's not going to get you nowhere with her.
But you putting yourself in a sucker situation where all the bitches you fuck with in the future is going to look at you like you still with the other bitch and you a weirdo.
You a beta male for real. Super beta male activity. I had to learn, you know what I'm saying? Like, you got to be on some alpha shit, bro.
It's fucked up out here, man. It's fucked up out here, man.
You can have a good heart, man, but everybody not gonna care about that shit. The world is just so conditioned to be so heartless and cold. Like, people don't care about that shit. Especially women. A lot of these women is damaged. You know, you never know what they grew up going through. They might have been molested, never had a good father in their life, so they resent men. They don't even really know how a good man is, so they just...
Yeah, you gotta...
It's a lot of shit,
you
bro.
You gotta vet your bitches, man.
It's
like,
a lot of variables.
You gotta vet your bitches heavily, man. I damn near gotta do a whole new show in Vet Your Bitches. Because a lot of niggas do not question they bitches thoroughly to find out what they working with. They just deal, especially a bad bitch. They go off looks alone. I'm taking it down. I'm doing whatever. I'm going raw. I'm doing whatever with this bitch.
I like a female that can read. That's sexy to me. Open up a book and read. You know what I mean? Articulate, you know what I'm saying? Have a good command of the English language. That's sexy.
Okay, that's a foundation, but then what if the bitch is evil? You gotta find
out. Her morals
too. You gotta find out if she a fucking demon.
She gotta be spiritual. I know the type of woman I need, she gotta be spiritual. She gotta be morally sound, you know what I mean? She gotta love the Most High more than I do. You know what I mean? Because if they don't, the rest of these females, they gonna follow after their heart. And if it's in their heart, then they ain't gonna feel nothing wrong about it.
Hey, man.
They don't give a fuck how you feel, the next person. And then a lot of women just work off emotions.
Hey, man.
We work off logic. They just, however they feel at that time, then they gonna go with it. They ain't gonna think about logically how it's affecting nobody. They just selfish like that.
Hey, man.
Not all of them. Not all y'all.
Have you ever encountered bitches that you thought might have been doing magic and shit like that?
I'm saying that's real. There's a lot of sorcerers, bro. It's witches for real, bro. We gonna get into it.
Have you really talked to a bitch and she just really looked at you and was like, "Yeah, I practice Wicca, this and that." Nah.
Ain't nobody really came out and told me that, but you never know what they. What they learn from their mamas or their grandmas or aunties. You have? Have
bro,
you?
Hey, man, I've heard that type of shit before, man.
Look at Erykah Badu. Hey, I think Erykah Badu is a witch. No disrespect. I love your music.
Hey, man. And you have to be aware of bitches like that out here.
That's
and I
real
think
shit,
niggas
bro.
Don't even. I think niggas don't even be
thinking. They're not even
like
aware
that.
Of that. They just, don't even know what they.
I'm just taking down bitches, but this bitch is taking it super serious.
She on some supernatural shit with you.
Her family is involved in the shit.
That part.
You know, you got a bitch who mama might be into that.
Practicing.
And she mad, and the moms is mad at you. The daughter in there crying. What you crying for?
Mom's going to cut and just whip out some shit.
My nigga done shitted on me.
Got some shit from the Botanica we were talking about earlier and going to cut in the closet and go by the altar and
bro.
Just.
Bro.
And then
bro,
you fucked up. You don't even know what
bro,
happened. Like, what the fuck?
Bro. That Santa Rhea type shit. The high priest, he don't have no job. He high priest all day. And what he do, how he high priest all day, motherfuckers coming to him like, I want to put a curse on this motherfucker. I want to put a curse on this motherfucker. Get this motherfucker over here. This motherfucker over here.
This shit is real, bro.
You don't even fucking know.
People listening to us probably think we crazy. What the fuck is them niggas talking about? Y'all do y'all research. Google this shit. Don't believe what we saying. Don't take our word for it, but just do your research on it. Then see what you come up with.
I be like, man, bro.
You ain't got to take my word. That's why I tell you, don't take my word for it. Who am I?
Hey, man.
Just research it, though. See for yourself.
Hey, man. It's real out here. Okay, so what...
What's next for you musically, man? What's your next moves you got going coming up, man?
I mean, as crazy as it seems, man, I'm just...
Because I know you just dropped a new project out there.
Man, Life Behind Bars, Volume 1. You know what I mean? That shit everywhere on all platforms on that piff. You know what I mean? Go tune in. That's just me doing my lyrical exercise shit. And I got the Beautiful Struggle EP. That's out. That's still out. Yeah. You know what I mean? If y'all ain't never heard it, you know what I mean? That's me on some original beats. So for you niggas, be like, well, let me hear you on some original shit. That's right. Well, song structure, song. Like I said, I got my boy on there on the Gotta Do singing.
Yeah.
With the vocals. So I just want to keep working, bro. Staying consistent. You know what I mean? Pumping out more projects.
Yeah, I've been really playing. I like that cut, Gotta Do, man. I really fuck with that cut.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Honestly, man.
Y'all shot a video for that? Y'all
we bought to. And honestly, how I came upon that, that was my boy. You know what I'm saying? That was his joint. You know what I'm saying? And then he asked me to get on the verse. So I'm like, okay. I didn't want to do it. You know what I'm saying? Because I like taking time writing my verses. So we got in the studio. I just pinned that shit up real quick. That shit came out real quick. Yeah, then I'm like, bro, let me put that on the EP. And he blessed me. He let me put it on the EP.
Who did that beat?
I don't know where he got the beat from, bro. He picked the beat. I ain't, you know what I mean? I'm going to keep it 100. We be on YouTube and shit, just you know what I mean? Having an ear for this shit, you know what I mean? Because we try to reach out to producers and they be on some bullshit like they Timbaland or something. Like they just got the ultimate rapport.
Niggas
wanna charge a nigga.
Hey, nigga, I feel you, man. I be finding beats and just finding shit and just rhyme to that shit and put that shit up. Fuck that.
No,
shit.
I go.
Hey, that's what's up, man. Yeah, that shit smooth, man. That's a good song, man. That's a good vibe, man.
Mm-hmm.
I see some visuals.
Like 30
for that.
Minutes, bro. Like 30 minutes, bro.
I see some visuals.
Well, shit, you ready to direct it, man? We can direct it. We want to do it soon. We could do that shit tomorrow, bro. Ready to do it tomorrow. We got somebody ready to film it. He could do that shit tomorrow, man.
He said, I'm ready to film that shit tomorrow.
He just hollered at me earlier, like, man, I got a camera, man. You want to shoot that shit? I'm like, man, you ain't even tell me or nothing. This nigga so spontaneous. I plan shit out. This nigga be on the fly. He don't give a fuck. I try to have my shit premeditated.
I don't know, man. That shit just look kind of dope, man. I don't know, man. I could see niggas.
I was thinking, okay, having me, you know, somewhere like writing some shit, some incense burning, just on some smooth shit, just. He was talking about being in the Benz and riding out. He want to do the extra extravagant budget.
I was in the Tesla X though with the bitch. Like, it's a good with a nigga in the past. He said, nigga wasn't even driving.
He said the Tesla X.
I was thinking of the nigga in the passenger seat with the bitch driving.
See, if we had that type of budget, we could do it. Because I don't own a Tesla. We could, of course, if we had the bread, we could rent that. You know what I'm saying? Hey, we gonna get there. We gonna get there for sure, for sure. And for sure, you gonna get your credits, man. Directed by Boss Mac, man. We gonna work for sure. You know, you my big homie, man. We from the same section. The least we can do is some music. That's nothing.
We put the drone on you on the way to Vegas.
I got the cameraman. My cameraman, he from out here. He from Long Beach, man. Shout out my boy Cali World ENT. That's the nigga that shoot all my shit. He be shooting visuals for Crooked Eye when they do the Crooks Corner.
Uh-huh.
He was shooting shit for Nipsey, for the Puma shit before he died. Like, bro was tapped in. Like, you might even know the dude. Like,
did he shot your visuals for what you did in Long Beach?
Of them. Every video I got, he shot every last one of them, bro. Every last one of them, bro. Like, I met him on Corlette. He was fucking with D. You know what I'm saying? He the one I shot the documentary for D. The hood documentary.
Okay.
He got all the footage for that shit. I met him then. He was like, oh, yeah, you dope. I want to work with you. You know what I'm saying? And I ran across him again like a couple months ago. You know what I mean? He's like, you ready to work? I'm like, I'm ready, bro. Let's do it. You know what I mean? And we just been pumping shit out, man. Like, I got to shout out bro, man. Like, he really elevated my career, bro. Like, I... far as the visuals.
Yeah, the visuals is cool, man. I saw niggas out there hiking too, man. That hiking was pretty cool too.
Yeah,
man.
Y'all
niggas was out there, man.
Yeah, we was out there in
Did y'all shoot something out there?
Nah, we was thinking about it. We was thinking about it. That was Gabrielino Canyon, like an Altadena type shit. But man, I heard this is.
I thought you was finna get on your Souls of Mischief. You know, Souls of Mischief did that shit back in the day.
We gonna do some shit, man.
Souls of Mischief had a dope. Their first video was that, like, in the wilderness.
Yeah.
I forgot the
name. I'm gonna lock that in the memory banks. I'm for sure I'm gonna do that.
I forgot the name of that song, but yeah.
I'm for sure. I heard this is a little hiking spot where they got, like, a bunch of old schools out there, just out there.
Uh-huh.
My boy was telling me, like, they got a bunch of old Chevys and shit out there, just out there. And it's like a waterfall. So we most definitely got some shit in the making, man.
That shit just be cool, man. Like, different environments is always cool, and bitches.
Man, for sure. You know, we from the city, man. Like, you go up there on a hike, there's no camera, there's no signals, no service. You know what I mean? So can't nobody call you and bug you, and there's just no helicopters, no.
Was y'all like
birds.
Runyon? Was that Runyon?
That's called Gabrielino Trail. Okay. It's Altadena. You know what I mean?
Okay, yeah.
You know, I appreciate that type of shit, man. The beach, anywhere where it's peaceful and tranquil, a little lot of tranquility, man. I appreciate that shit, man.
Yeah, man, that's what's up, man. I appreciate that shit. Okay, let me see. I wanted to address something else. Oh yeah, man. I had. I had something, man, and you know. Your first album was dedicated, your first project dedicated to your bro, J. Rue.
Yeah, man. It's like my first cousin, man, but we was like brothers, man. Jason Allen Martin, I had the hood know him as J. Rue, man, child. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I had to, as long as I'm alive, I gotta keep my bro memory alive with me, man. I put him on the cover. He on the cover of my second joint, too. Like, yeah. Behind bars, he on the back, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I saw that.
You know? Top, man.
Yeah, man.
That's like my ill will. Now it's how ill will. I got J. Rue. You know what I'm saying?
I feel ya. Well, man, I had something I wanted to say about him, man. I had some weird shit happen to me with the homies, kind of like to where it happened with Jake. It happened with Mossberg, and it happened with your boy, right?
Okay. We lost some cold niggas,
okay,
man.
Okay, now look.
We lost some real niggas,
now
bro.
Now, this is some real
rest
shit.
Rest in peace, my nigga Money Nut. His birthday just passed. We did it big for my nigga Nut, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
We lost a lot of real solid individuals, bro. And I'd be like, why they died? Then it'd be a lot of bitch-ass niggas still here. But that, I'm not God, I can't make that decision. But I'd be like,
let me tell you what happened. All right. The last time I seen Jake,
mm-hmm.
Right? He had came by the crib. We was blowing kush, chopping it up about something. And he was finna go on a trip, right? And he was like, man, you know, you gotta come out of the crib and smoke some weed. You know what I'm saying? Ooh. I was like, yeah, all right, yeah. So he went across the street and was waiting to get in the car to go,
mm-hmm.
Whoever was driving. And something just said, look at your boy. And I just.
Oh, I know, I know what you're getting with.
I just stared at him and focused on him for like. About a few minutes, bro. Just really watched him right there just the whole time. And then he got in the car and left.
Man.
And then I never seen him alive again, right?
That's crazy, man.
Okay, here's the second time. Mossberg had just left my crib.
And that shit happened to him?
No. He had left my crib.
Mm-hmm.
He was chopping it up. And he went outside and was waiting to leave. And someone was like, look at your boy.
That's that Holy Spirit in us, bro.
And I just watched Marsburg out there. I just watched him out there waiting to go get in the car.
You don't even know why you did it.
How he was moving around, you know, what he was doing. How that somebody.
Rest in peace, Marsburg, the realest, man. Rest in peace, Marsburg, the realest, man. For sure, for sure.
Third time it happened. I was sitting on my mother's porch. Check him out. And I just watched him. Like, walk by. I just really studied him and watched him.
No, man. Rest in peace, my boy, man. J. Rule, man.
Man. So I don't know. I don't know what that type of shit is. You know what I'm saying?
We all got gifts, man.
I don't know what that type of shit is. But that happened to me them three times.
I know some tell you to watch me. You better call me back. Some tell you to watch me. You better call me back, nigga. Tell me something. Hey, hold up, man. I just got that intuition. That's the premonition, nigga. Take the strap with you.
I try to tell niggas all the weird shit that happened. Like if
nothing weird about it, man. We all got gifts, bro. Just like all the people in the Bible, Solomon, Samson, Joseph, Daniel. Yeah. We the same people the Most High, man. We got gifts, bro, and talents, man. Like, this shit deep. This shit spiritual out here, man.
Okay, in close.
You want to ask me what last time I seen my dude or something? That's what you was getting to? Like,
nah, my point was that it was,
cause I had like one of those moments with him too.
Something just made me look at these three niggas, like, and you know, I was cool with J. Rue, but I wasn't cool with him like I was cool with Jake
and
Mossberg. But
we was still, little homies. We was a little homies.
It's still that I had that experience though. Like, look at this nigga. Observe him right now. Take it in. What do you know?
I had one of those moments too with him, man. Last time I seen him, I was at my grandma's house and I was in there ironing some clothes. And he pulled up. That's when he had one of his little chick he was fucking with at the time. She had like a white Explorer. He pulled up. I'm in there ironing. And he pulled up banging a Juvenile with the 400 degrees shit. That's when that shit first came. It was being out, but he was just banging that shit. And I'm in there, I was banging some new Jay-Z, some new State Prop shit.
Yeah.
He was like, alright, I'm finna go get my hair cut, whatever. That's the new Nextels is out. You know, I'm gonna hit you with a Nextel, whatever. He's like, nigga, you heard when I pull up, I mean, nigga, you don't know nothing about this. I'm like, nigga, you hear what I'm banging, nigga? You don't know nothing about this shit, nigga. But niggas don't know about J-Rue. He was cold on the mic. He can rap like a motherfucker too, bro. Like, he was cold, cold, cold. Like, if he was for sure alive, we'd be like the Locks or something. Like, that nigga was cold, bro. And I'd be hating like that we never even know what we had. We could have been a cold duo, bro. And I was like the older cousin. Like, I was like a month and a half older than him, but
yeah,
I ain't gonna get too deep, man. I be hating that, man.
I feel you, bro.
I be wishing it was, man. I blame myself for a lot of that shit, man.
It's rough. I ain't mean to be bringing up no thing, but I always was like, when I talk to this nigga, I'ma tell him about that I had that type of experience with them niggas, you know, with all these niggas, you know. It's just weird, man. You know, it's just weird. And Mossberg, you know, Mossberg.
That nigga was great, bro. That nigga was great. He was like our Biggie.
Mossberg?
Hell yeah.
You know I used to like coach Mossberg, right?
Yeah. I can imagine.
You know Mossberg came.
I know he know about what y'all was doing.
You know Mossberg came to me like and was like, I can rap.
He said, I can spit, nigga.
I can rap. Look, Mossberg came to me like and was like, hey man, I can rap.
For real, for real.
My name is Big John.
Back he then, you weren't even Mossberg.
You feel me? I'm saving all the money from my dice game winning to go to the studio, man. To listen. I don't have no beats. I'm making up shit in the studio.
with this motherfucker that's in here.
This is going
on. I'm telling
on.
Him what to sample and make this. And this. I'm just making it up. I'm just trying some shit.
Trying to do it, bro.
All my dice game winning, nigga.
I seen it.
Washington. Nigga was whack. Washington at horrible. And then just get better, better, better. To where you gotta take him serious. And then the nigga said, okay, niggas from Fruit Town fucking with me now. Hmm. I mean, niggas from Treetop fucking with me now.
Yeah, Tony Lane.
Niggas from Treetop fucking with me now.
Black Tone and DJ
and
Quick.
And he was still whack.
When I heard Bird, that nigga was cold to me.
I'm just
the Compton Block shit with him and Six Mills and all that old shit. We gonna turn Rosecrans into the show. Bro. That's the shit I heard. But I know you probably heard shit, you know what I mean? When I heard Berg, that nigga, that's why I didn't want to rap. Because I'm like, he another one of like them niggas that I grew up listening to. Bro, like born MCs.
I'm trying to tell you what I saw.
Nah, I believe you. For sure. Ain't no disrespect or none of that.
Made some kind of jump in skill level that was like
amazing.
It was like,
it's the epitome of practice makes perfect.
When a nigga find this voice in the middle of some shit, I think Lil Wayne kind of did that, because at first to me Lil Wayne was whack,
yeah, you from that era, though.
He became raw as fuck.
After
like,
that 500 degrees shit, then he started doing the prefix and the suffix and the mixtape
like,
shit.
Like, when he did.
He started going brazy.
That's my DJ. Go DJ. That's my
the
DJ.
Carter shit.
To me,
the Carter
he
shit.
Made a big jump right there.
Off top. Oh, yeah. Off top.
Wahlberg made a giant jump in his skill level. Like, he found his
he
voice.
He found the
something.
Niche. Hell yeah.
And that nigga went from okay to dope.
Upper echelon.
He went from okay to like, I'm putting extreme pressure. He went from
pressure.
He went
real.
From quick man going, damn, should we put this thing out? To
they got,
pressure.
They got behind that shit.
So I'm worried, low key jealous type shit, I think.
And he was still young.
Personally, I ain't trying to say some shit about no niggas. But,
it's the know, real niggas. A lot
when
of
I, when man. I review the material, you know, we was all like,
man, that nigga was
back,
raw
back then. We was all like,
imagine if he was still alive today, the shit he'd be putting out. If he would have never died, imagine how his skills would have elevated. That's the shit that make me mad, frustrated. Thinking of,
I don't know.
I compare that to like Biggie and Pac, cause they died young.
I don't know, man.
They was like 24 and 25 when they done. Imagine if they were still here. The shit, the substance matter, cause everybody matures and evolves. Imagine
okay,
if they
okay,
were still alive.
Okay, I hope Mossberg. I hope, cause see, like I said, that's coaching Mossberg, bro.
Mm-hmm.
This shit that I'm doing now, I was doing then. You feel me?
Lord.
So, you know, I was worried about Mossberg as he was approaching fame, as he was approaching like
just notoriety, just exposure.
Because he was famous. He was lit.
I think
he
did songs with Nate Dogg Quick. Like,
bro.
R. Kelly. Before the bullshit.
Bro. 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 Bro.
It don't get no bigger than that.
Bro.
The Connected Project.
Bro, he wrote the verse for Snoop shit in my living room in my mom's crib.
Yeah.
Matter of fact, I told him what the elements to add in there.
Right.
The type of, I told him like
subject matter.
You wanna describe the shit in your crib. You wanna describe why bitches is over here leaking information about you. You understand me? You wanna describe why it's happening? Well, I'm telling you. But I was
yeah,
a little
historical shit,
I was
bro.
A little worried about Mossberg because he was going into the realm of bitches, and I don't think he was prepared for the bitches on that level, because, you know, like, he had, you know, like,
he was a street nigga, man. Like,
you know,
you
coming from Nella, bro. Like, you coming from the hood. Like,
you know how
you
the
know
hood
what
is,
saying?
Bro. This
so
shit is the grimiest of the grimy.
Like,
bad bitches, bro.
You know,
like
high
that,
yellow, bad ones. The surround is trying to, you know, quick.
That shit can fuck up your focability.
So I was concerned. I was trying to have him ready for that.
Yeah.
Because that was going
to
be, that was going
to
policy,
be,
that was going to be,
that could be a downfall.
That would distract you, get you off your square.
Yeah,
you know,
man.
You get focusing on a bitch.
Evil ass women.
And then,
here,
and see, one bitch, and see, I had to correct him too.
Not all y'all, just some of y'all.
I had to help him out too. I had to help him, like, control his emotions, because, you know, once he started moving around with Quick Mem, and you know what I'm saying, then, you know, he'd be at a show or something, and a bitch, you know, a choose and want to be fucking with him, and then he not, you know, he take the bitch backstage. You feel me? Like
groupie shit that come with the rap
bit,
shit.
A little bit premature, like, you know, because his
he not seasoned. He don't know what come with this shit.
He ain't at high power yet. Quick in them is the power. You know what I'm saying? So they can take your bitches from you. Like, when you take bitches backstage around these other higher level niggas, now they can take your bitches.
They be groupies like
so
that.
So what happened to him was he took a bitch backstage, right?
Mm-hmm.
And was mingling with her and having a drink, doing his parlay, you know what I'm saying? Celebrities around.
I think I heard about that.
She with me.
And she like, I don't know who you is, type shit.
How
was that one?
No, it went like this. So he politicking backstage and shit with her, got her back there and shit, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, exchange information with her, and you know, we're gonna do some stuff in the future together. But he had her back there in that atmosphere, and a couple of times off of it, right? And he, you know, she like mingled into the crowd and was gone and came back type of shit a couple of times. So what happened was he ended up going to the studio to meet up with Quick Mem a few nights later or some shit. And when he walked in there,
the bitch was up
bitch
in there
sitting.
I mean, but shit, I mean, he was young.
And
you
see,
know?
And see, that's why I'm trying to get him ready for. I'm like,
it's
look,
gonna
bro.
Happen, man. They gonna choose
so,
up.
So his emotions.
He felt some type of way, though.
Toward Quick. And I was like,
nah, you
like,
can't be
nah,
mad at Quick.
Like, I was like, yo, you.
Them type of females, they for everybody, bro. They just, they fuck with the game.
I was like, Quick is gonna save you, nigga.
Yeah, don't get mad
bitch,
over no female.
Don't
like,
let the bitch, but it's still fucked with him.
It's just an ego, egotistical thing.
You feel me?
You
like,
feel like you had her first.
See, he don't even. I'm not really. I'm just starting to get bitches like
they hold that. Yeah.
But see,
yeah.
Niggas not you. That's what I'm talking
yeah,
about.
I know you're talking
I'm
about.
I'm not used to having these kind of bitches.
Yeah.
She chose up at a show that I've been waiting for this to happen. You know what I'm saying? We're going backstage, pulling up Hennessy. Man. Blowing
I still had to learn about all that shit, man.
You know what I'm saying? I'm feeling good.
Females like
bitch.
That, they for everybody, bro. You can't fall
but
in love
see,
with
but see, he not
like
tripping.
That.
He not tripping on niggas watching him go, oh, he got a bad
one. They probably weren't even tripping.
And
she came back
yeah.
and just was, she probably, I mean, she gonna want Quick. She want the high power type shit. She probably was just using blood to get the Quick. You know what I mean? Like, that ain't nothing
and
you
so
fall
I
in love
had to,
with.
Like I said, early. So early, I was like, yo, man.
You schooling him, like, man, look, don't trip off.
Have no emotion.
That's going to happen a thousand. That's going to happen a thousand times. Man, I learned that, man, from my previous. You can't have no emotional attachments to nothing, man. Expect the worst.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's fucked up, but that's just how it is. You know what I mean? Especially with certain women.
Yeah, and another thing I used to tell him, too, man, is, like, he used to be, you know, he was Quick was point man.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody else had to try to fuck with Quick. Quick, you know, I just make the beats and manipulate the equipment. You know what it is.
He's a genius,
the
bro.
The studio is at his crib, right?
Musical genius, bro.
The studio
show
is at his crib. Everybody got issues with Quick. Free, 7-9. Everybody got issues. Niggas is mad. It's all kind of emotions.
Mm-hmm.
So I told Berg, I was like, hey, man, stay up under quick. Be over there every day. And when you're ready to record, be ready to go.
Mm-hmm.
Be ready to go every time. Every time, every time, every time, every time you're ready to go, be ready to go. Absolutely. Just be over there buying. And just be ready to work.
Locked and loaded.
Don't be ready to bullshit. Don't be ready to do nothing but rap.
Go in.
And that nigga got on hella cuts using that method.
Right.
That's
real
big
homie shit.
The niggas was over there trying to argue with him and shit.
That's real
I was
big
like,
homie
fuck
shit,
that. Where can I get on there at? Oh, I can put 16 right here. Okay.
Quick scene that. Like, okay, Berg ain't tripping off that shit. Like, you know, that's good guidance you gave, you know.
And next thing you know, that nigga was.
Took off. That's good instruction you was giving him, man. That's a big homie shit. For real, man.
That shit was crazy, man.
I hate that shit happened to bro, man. I hate that shit happened to Berg, man. For real, man. Because, I mean, the world look at him as Marsberg. I look at him as, you know, Big John, Bear, J-Bone, the homie. Like, you know, when he died so young, man. And he didn't deserve that, man. He didn't deserve that, man.
Some way out type of
shit like that put a whole black cloud over the hood. We just now resurging from that to where we got a little good momentum. You know what I'm saying? What we doing as far as the rapping? That's why shit like that, maybe he didn't even want to rap. I'm like, man, if I might get to a certain status, niggas might even start hating on me, want to take me out, or just, you know, shit. A nigga lets whatever happen to me and it won't protect me. I'm gonna have to protect myself. That's why I'm the way I am. That's why I move the way I move, man. Like,
that's come with it, bro. That it's what it is that magnification. When you become magnified,
mm-hmm.
and that play bizarre tricks on niggas' minds around you.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? And it was fascinating watching that happen to Marsberg.
Man.
Because he was like
he was one of us, for real.
Like, he was like a big presence in the hood. Like, you always seen him, like, walking down the street.
He was really
like, you could just look at the park and see him over there in the park. Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
I mean, we used to be at the park. He'd be shooting threes. He'd be up there dunking, playing ball.
That nigga was.
I'd be shooting dice. I mean, we was all shooting dice by the pool. And the police come. He like, oh, yeah, but I'm finna hit this one more time. And I'm out of here. Bro. Hit the blood one time. And the police came. By the time the police pulled up on us, you see that nigga. He just stepped over his gate. You know, we stayed right behind the park.
Yeah.
That nigga just took he just stepped. He bent the whole gate down. That nigga was in the backyard.
Yeah.
I'm like, fuck.
Nigga, look. Nigga. I think for like about 2, maybe 3 years, like 2, maybe 3 years, I think from like 98 to like, well, 98 to 2000, that nigga came. I used to report to my mom's apartment like a job in the morning to hustle, like, because I had that was my operation.
Mm-hmm.
So I operate out the kitchen.
Mm-hmm.
So I used to report there like an office every day. And he met me in the morning every day. And we link up and go get some espresso across the street from El Camino College. It was an espresso shop. Chop it up. Discuss how he's going to get at Quick Nim today. You know, how you gonna do it today? What's happening? What's going on with Quick, man? What type of scenario?
So
is
how you link up with Quick? You know that?
Through Black Tone. Cause what Black. It was back in the days when Quick first came out. Quick got banned from his hood for some type of snitching something.
I heard.
Black Tone was
the muscle
was out to get him back then.
Yeah.
And then when Jake came out the pen, discovered that they had that type of turmoil amongst them between Black Tone, Second to None, and
all that.
Let me fix this shit.
Mm-hmm.
So Jake kind of
smooth, however they did it, smoothed it over.
That's what's up,
and
man.
Then, so Black Tone and Quick started doing business. And then Black Tone then wanted to get a record label going. But that's after Jake had died.
The Shepherd Lane shit.
Right, and that's when he hooked up with, now Stan Shepherd was like some type of slick old school player type of dude from music, you know. He basically got over on Black Tone. Basically, he used Black Tone for the muscle and the influence to kind of finesse. That had an impact on Marsburg as well, because he took the majority of Marsburg money. See, what it was,
I know. I heard.
What put Marsburg in a twist was because Marsburg became famous and was like, he became magnified.
Hella fan base, bro.
He became magnified. He didn't have no video or nothing yet. There wasn't even no visuals. There wasn't even. I mean, he had them live performances that's out there, but there wasn't.
Before prevalent. Social media, it was just word of mouth.
So he didn't have no videos, nothing. So he was getting ready to go. He was getting ready to pop. And and then I think he had like. In music, man, if you pay attention, sometimes if you pay attention to motherfuckers, you see motherfuckers have a defining moment, like some type of performance or something where it was like they was like this before the performance and then after it was like this.
Take off.
Now, a obvious defining moment for an artist would be like Michael Jackson when he did the 25. When I don't know if y'all seen that. When he Michael Jackson Motown 25 when he did Billie Jean live for the first time. He was lip syncing that shit and it changed the world. It was a performance to change the world. Like it was before this.
It was live shit. Everything sounded
live. And after
live.
This, it changed the world. Marsburg had a defining performance like that.
That changed the game shit.
A live performance that he did at USC DJ Quick and them opened for Boyz II Men. DJ Quick opened for Boyz II Men. So Marsburg came out. But now, see, Marsburg is buzzing out there. They've been playing Shut Up on the radio. A lot of college radio been fucking with him. He been buzzing. But it's hard to tell if shit is resonating with the people.
Until you do it live.
Until the nigga come out.
And they see you.
And he like, shut up, nigga. You fucking with my family. And the whole crowd is doing
he was,
that.
He was there?
Shut up, nigga. No, this is what I heard about.
Right.
Now, this
impact.
This is... And listen, I was going to go to the performance, but I blew it off. I was hustling some shit at the crib. I'm seeing niggas gather together to get ready to go. We going to USC, Marsburg. I'm going to catch the next one like it's going to be a whole bunch of them. You feel me?
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Off top.
After that performance, the reason why I know it was a defining
moment
for him is because I seen the niggas faces afterwards.
Like they was just amazed.
One nigga for sure was Frog.
Big Frog from Cedars?
No. What's his name, brother? Dante brother.
From the hood,
brother. When y'all came over here to do the podcast.
Oh, you talking about Fabian?
Not Fabe, the other nigga. His brother.
Dante, Turtle.
Turtle,
yes. Oh, nigga, Turtle.
I got the wrong phone.
Yeah, nigga, Turtle, man. So how about nigga Turtle, man?
I saw
man.
Turtle. Turtle looked like he had seen Jesus. You understand me? He was like, man, this nigga Marsburg, man. Tennessee.
Man, you don't know, man.
Like he was born again.
Bro, they was mosh pitting. I was like, whoa. Turtle, man. Nigga, they booed. Shit. They booed Boys to Men.
Because they wanted more Berg, huh? Like, what the fuck is these niggas out of here?
Because Berg was so lit. They booed Boys to Men.
That's crazy. At SC?
At SC.
That's crazy. What year was this?
This was like 98, something like that, yeah. The Connected Project was out there.
Right, right.
You know
right.
what I'm saying? I'm telling you, man.
I think it gave me one of them motherfuckers, man.
I'm telling you.
It gave me one of them motherfuckers. I remember Berg told me, man, like, man, I'm telling you, Lil Vebo, man, this shit pop, we gonna be straight. And I'd be like, man, you know, I ain't tripping, bro, man. I like to see you do your thing. Like, nah, I promise you, fuck that, bro. We gonna be, I'm finna take off, bro. We gonna be straight. And that's before, this way before, I wasn't even thinking about rapping. I always was a fan of the music. Always,
yeah, yeah.
But I wasn't even, and I think about that shit now. I know Berg, wherever he at, he probably would've slapped me upside my head. Like, blood, you had this in you the whole time, blood. Why the fuck you wasn't doing this when I was down there? But he had it, cause I'm like, shit, you got it, big bro. Like, you got it. Shit, I'm, and just like, man.
And then,
if him and Big Jake was alive, man, the hood would be totally different, man. Them two losses, man, that shit fucked the hood up, man. Shit like that made me don't even want to just, you know.
Yeah,
I'm like, man, fuck that industry shit, man. Like, now I'm like, okay, shit, I'm a product of that, man. I gotta keep it going. I gotta do something.
You know, some funny shit too. Some other funny shit too. I just want to mention, man, like on the influence of Jake.
Man,
look,
niggas don't know look. About.
You know, like, man. You know, like, when Suge did that famous speech, like, boy, if you want
to
be a rapper,
come
you don't want
to see him dancing all in the videos,
all in the video,
dancing.
Come to Death Row. Listen to me. Vebo.
Yes, sir.
Suge's body movement.
It was Jake.
In words.
The big homie off top. Minus the fake
and
bully
I,
shit.
And when I saw the tape, because Jake brought the tape to us, right after they did it, brought it straight to the crib for us to see. Soon as I saw.
Tell these niggas,
he's
man.
He's like, look what Suge did.
Tell these
soon
niggas.
As soon as I saw Suge do that, I was like,
I showed Jake, Junior.
This nigga copying you, Jake. You don't see it.
Niggas
I'm
don't
like,
know
you
that.
You influencing they whole shit like
but
that.
But see, Jake.
Yeah. Seen a car full of girls. They don't need to tweak. All of you search. Know what's up with 213.
First of all, I'd like to thank God. Second of all, I'd like to thank my whole entire Death Row family on both sides, you know what I'm saying? I'd like to tell Tupac to keep his guards up. We ride with him. And one other thing I'd like to say, any artist out there want to be an artist and want to stay a star, and don't want to have to worry about the executive producer trying to be all in the video, all on the record, dancing. Come to Death Row.
Wasn't a bully like that. He was really that nigga. Suge was just, no disrespect to nobody from over there, but niggas
like,
know
man.
That nigga won. That's my big homie. I don't give a fuck. Anybody got a problem?
I was like, man.
I'm accessible, bro. I ain't worried about none of that shit. But that's my big homie, bro. All the mannerisms is my big. It's just real historical. Anybody that's from that era know that. A lot of these niggas don't know that.
I was like, man, look at that. And he is famous for that.
For that shit.
He's
but,
famous.
But you know, but we know that he wasn't a bully though like that. But like we was talking about earlier, like his peoples is Black Panthers and revolutionaries, so he had that. he had the activist in him, so he wasn't like with oppressing our people, bro. Like, just doing what you need to do when it need to be done. Suge was on some whole other shit.
Man, man.
But all the whole that whole mannerism, that was like, I'm glad you brought that up, bro. I'm glad you brought that up.
I was like, man. Cause you
older than me, so you know him more than I do.
Oh, yeah, man.
So you can say this shit. So it ain't like I'm tripping. It's just real shit.
I remember even watching Suge lose his mind. Like, I observed Suge lose his mind.
Yeah.
Because let me outline how.
See, but Death Row was like a $500 million corporation and company, bro. I'm not disrespecting none of that.
But let me.
They sold a lot of records, bro. A lot of talent came from Death Row. Let me outline
how he lost his mind. Let me show you. Let me detail it for you. In the G-Thang video, Suge is in the G-Thang video.
Yeah.
Can you see him?
Shit, now that you think about it, I wasn't even paying attention to him. I just remember them pouring the memorable moments, when he was pouring the 40s on old girl in the end.
Nah, I want you to, you know what Suge looked like. So,
I'm gonna watch that shit tonight. You don't remember him in the video?
I
wasn't even paying attention to bro. Just Dre and Snoop.
He's in the video.
Yeah.
And I remember when Jake was like, Suge in the video.
Why he want to be in the video?
Listen. He was like, Suge is in the video. Why? Oh, man. It occurred to me. It made me think. I was like, this nigga Suge is a genius. Because he's in the back. He don't want to be in the front. I thought this in 1992. He's a genius. But then over time, slowly, it's not coming out.
Right.
To where, when I made the declaration that the end was here for him, I was like, this is the end for Suge right
here. You've seen it.
This
huh?
is the end right here. When he was on the cover of the Source with all red on.
The red joint.
Red shoes on with his arms
around
on
Snoop.
Both of them niggas.
And Dre.
Like, he was the main artist. I was like, this nigga has officially lost his mind.
And then
Jake used to tell me about his antics that I couldn't foresee. I was questioning Jake. Like, I was like, Jake, man, that's some weird type shit. Like, Suge used to do shit like, nigga be driving down the street and, like, say he have a bitch to live right here, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like, I'm Suge and you Jake. I'm driving down the street and I just like, it's a bitch right here, hold up. And I pull over and go to the door.
Listen, while
you watching,
randomly
knock on the door, she come to the door, nigga bend her over, pull down her panties and fuck her right there on the porch. Bust a nut. Then jump back in the car and be like, yeah, I just had to get that nut off right quick, man.
Kind of weird ass shit to do in front
now,
of
how many
a
nigga. Niggas,
why would you do
how
that?
How many niggas have you ever seen
do some shit like that, bro? Never, bro.
And what the fuck? What's the
what are you trying to show me? What is the purpose, bro? Why are you showing me this? What are you trying to convey to me? How is that impressing me? I was asking Jake.
I was like, Jake, what? You don't think that's some weird ass shit, bro? You don't think that's like, what is the
thought process behind that? What is the thesis behind that?
I just thought I'd share it.
That's real shit.
You know what I'm saying?
That's how we get every time I'm here, man. It's gonna be number real shit.
You know what I'm saying?
We're gonna elaborate on it, man. And we're gonna back it up. If anybody's tripping. But I'm a rapper, though. I'm a peaceful guy. Don't come at me with no bullshit.
All right, shit. We about 2 hours in right now, sir.
That's a good, man. That shit went by fast, man.
Like 2 hours in.
Yes, indeed. I appreciate you for having me here, man. For real, man.
Yeah, man.
Shout out my nigga, my big homie Boss Mac. This is my big homie, man. My OG, man.
Hey, man. It's all good.
Appreciate it.
Hey, we gonna. And whenever you feel like getting some shit off your chest, bro. Like, if you like, hey, man, I gotta get some shit off my chest, man.
Say when I'm ready to get controversial.
Well, say, man, some shit. I didn't agree with that shit I just saw.
Well, so, you going to get the first look.
I'm going to get my eyes off, right? I need to get my eyes off, man. Let me come sit here, man. I need to get it off. So
we going to get on the Boss Mac podcast, man, yeah, and let them know. Let the Boss Mac family know.
Yeah, man. I'm starting trying to rotate the homies through here. I got to get all the homies through here. Man.
Hey, the homies is dope, man. Shout out Rose Clan's ENT, man. We got niggas, man. Mari Ruger up next.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Hop Out. You know what I mean? YS. You know what I mean? My nigga Hayes, Boogaloo, Lil Zo. You know what I'm saying? All the homies, man. Money.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Kelbo. Kelbo, you know what I'm saying? We got this. The movement is strong, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, we just trying to keep going from what y'all did. You know what I mean?
Hey, man, it's looking good, man. I see y'all niggas doing y'all thing, man. You know what I mean?
You know what I mean? I be in the hood. I be with my same people, man. I be with T-Bone. You know what I mean? My nigga Tay. I don't be with much, man. I ain't hard to find, man. I don't do too much, man.
I got to get. Oh, your boy from the 48 Teal Clothing.
Oh, yeah, Gutter, man. Shout out Gutter. Show Gutter, man. Shout out my nigga Show Gutter. He be lacing me up with the gear. You know what I mean?
That nigga, man. I like that
shit.
Nigga.
He got some shit, bro.
Yeah.
He got some cold shit, man.
Yeah.
Shout out my relative, Hustler Bubba. You know what I mean? He got the 24-hour lifestyle shit. We just trying to keep it going, man.
Hey, what's up with that nigga Greedo? You talk to him, man.
I wrote a letter to him probably like a few months ago, and he wrote me back. I need to write another letter to him, but his sentence is shorter than what niggas think, man.
Yeah.
So he gonna be home pretty soon. Shout out to my nigga Greedo, man. My nigga 03, man. Free my nigga 03.
How you doing in there? Did you talk to him or just wrote a letter?
Just wrote a letter, man. You know, he's straight, though. You know, he's straight. That nigga took off, bro. I remember when that nigga, before all this old shit, yeah, that nigga streams and views is at millions, bro. He took off. So he's straight. He gonna be straight when he come home.
Yeah.
For sure. That little case he ran into, you know what I mean? I just fucked up the momentum, but he gonna get right back to it. So he gonna be straight.
Yeah, I like that nigga, man.
Yeah.
I like that.
He a smooth nigga.
Huh?
He a smooth nigga.
Yeah.
Yeah, he got me popping, man. That nigga tweeted I'm the best rapper from Compton that he ever heard. Like that shit. I'm like I saw niggas
chilling, man. Listen, man. Bro.
Man, that was my nigga before. Listen, man. I'm like, why did you put that? Now niggas gonna be mad at me.
Nigga.
That's a lot of pressure. Why are you telling niggas I'm the best?
I remember when I booked niggas. I had Joe Moses up at Cohiba's in downtown Long Beach. I don't know if you remember that.
The Shine Time
was opening for them.
Yeah, I remember. I didn't go to that one. I was supposed to go, but they told me about
man,
it.
Man, them niggas was horrible. Bro.
I know. Man, I heard about it. That's why I didn't want to go.
Was horrible. And them
I ain't not no disrespect, but you know what I mean? The homies used to be telling me back then, like, you better than all them niggas. Like, why is you? Because they used to be on some.
Bro, I remember Ed and
Ed, homie Cade, Bomb.
I remember Ed and
that's my niggas. Them are my niggas though. Ain't no disrespect. You know what
I
mean?
I remember that nigga Ed and Greedo had a cut, right?
Yeah.
It was a tight cut, right?
Yeah, yeah. They had a dope.
So niggas is Shine Time doing the show. And then Greedo came, right?
Mm-hmm.
Greedo is backstage with me. I'm like, nigga, why you back here with me, man? Niggas is up there in the front, hallucinating, yelling, jumping around. I'm like,
he's like hallucinating.
Why?
That's my Shy stages. I could have went to that show, but I didn't want to go.
My niggas.
I'm like, nah, I ain't going to that
my
shit.
My niggas got up there.
Cause I ain't really have a lot of cuts, you know what I'm saying? I just had like mixtape shit, right? I ain't trying to be all famous and do shows and shit. Y'all want to be seen. Like, we ain't got enough work yet. Y'all niggas.
Hey, man, I told niggas straight out. If any nigga get upset at what I'm saying, I told this back then when this happened.
Man,
you understand me?
Nobody from the dude, man.
Niggas
man.
Was.
Ain't from the dude, man.
Niggas was.
It's just the honest critique. Just honest critique.
Long man. Beach niggas was on my head talking bad to me, man. Like.
These your little homies.
These your homies. These.
Oh, shit. I'm like. It's just real shit, though. You know what I mean? They was. They style of shit that I do was different back then, man. They catered to something totally different, man. Like, I was on some different shit back then. You know what I mean? That's what I. But I appreciated them. I mean, every nigga that I done rap from the hood, I done fucked with them, man. I done fucked with Gutter on the Black Ops shit, Cabe on the Shine Time shit. You know what I mean? Like, just on, cause we all from the same hood, so I don't look at it as like on no rap shit. You know what I mean? So. It was a time where I didn't even want to rap. After that Shine Time shit, I was good on rapping. Cause I had a BlackBerry full of shit. That shit got crashed. I lost a gang of my rhymes and shit. The nigga stole the equipment. I got old mixtapes. I done wrote like 2 or 3 mixtapes full of shit back then, bro. All that shit. I'm like, man, fuck this rap shit, man. This shit ain't for me, man. Dude. Boogaloo one day, man. Boogaloo hit me. And he took me to the Red Room in Gardena, and we did a track, you know what I mean? And he was like, bro, that shit hard. He was like, man, you hard, man. Look, man, you need to become a group, man, to do some shit, man. I'm like, all right. So that's really what sparked me back up on this rap shit, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I'm like, fuck it, you know what I mean? Like, and then every time I try to run from it, then Guido put that post, like, I'm the best nigga he ever heard from Compton to Bronx. I'm like, blood, why is he? Once he did that, all type of niggas is following me and DMing me and shit. So I'm like, damn, I can't. Then I felt obligated, like I can't let niggas down, man. Like I gotta do something.
Yeah, that's facts, man.
Like, I gotta do something, man.
Can't squander the gift, man. You get the gift, man. God let you have his skills, man.
I was like Jonah for a long time, man. I tried to run and then I got swallowed up by the whale, man, and he spit me back up on shore.
You get punished for not using it, man. I'm here to tell you. Punished for not using it.
If anybody see what I'm doing now, it's because of that. You know what I mean? So now I believe in myself. I see it. You know what I mean? So niggas are fucked up now. You done fucked up. No, you done fucked up, right?
Okay, man. You know what, man? Elephant in the room, man. Before niggas get up off of here, man. Seem like niggas should be doing a cut with Boogie. What's up with that, man?
Man, that's like a whole nother episode, man. That's like
I had Boogie on the podcast before. I gotta have him back.
I mean, that's the bro. He DM'd me like probably like a couple weeks ago, and he's like, you know, I'm in your corner, bro. Whatever you're trying to do, I believe in you and all that sort type of shit, man.
Yeah, like, I mean, because he's super
dope, man.
He on the label with Conway,
all them niggas.
And he see that.
I don't think he liked them niggas like that, though.
It ain't about him. Oh, you talking about musically?
One day we did an interview, and I brought them niggas up. You know what I mean? I'm like, man, you over there with M and Royce and all that. And he's like, well, yeah, you know, if you like that Wu-Tang, 90s Wu-Tang type of sound type shit. I'm like, whoa.
Oh, okay. So he let you know where he stand.
I'm like, all right,
see, he
bro.
Be out there singing them love songs, man. I don't know,
I'm like,
man. All
right, man, you know. And I ain't no hater, man. I don't want to seem like no bully, nigga. Like, niggas know me on some street shit. I'm really one of them niggas, man. But I'm not trying to be like that in the music shit. That's why I try to use my lyrical capabilities. I don't want to be like,
my nigga.
I don't want to, you know what I mean? I don't want to scare nobody or none of that.
It ain't about that. I'm on a, like.
Because I'm from that real Nella we were just talking about. Okay. Big Jake, Mossberg, and all that old type
bro,
of shit. Y'all
my
big homies.
I'm not on no bully but, type of shit. I'm on some, like.
Just realistically.
Lanes. I mean, okay, we see it in different people.
I'm dope, bro. Like, niggas should want to fuck with me, bro. I know niggas hear about me now. When I first started,
now,
okay.
I will say this.
I know niggas know about me, bro.
I will say this. I'm not sure how much, if you was on one of his joints, that would help you.
I mean,
it would give you a boost.
I mean, but you know, I'm not looking for that. You know what I mean?
But look. It would give you a boost, but I just still think y'all in the same dimension musically. You know what I'm saying? Y'all might not be in the exact same But y'all in the same.
That's all I try to show niggas. I'm really lyrical, bro. Yeah. Like, I mean, when y'all tap in and ask niggas about them, they gonna tell you all that other shit, man. But I'm just trying to show y'all I'm lyrical. I'm intelligent. I'm versatile. I got wordplay. You know what I mean? Like, I got metaphors, similes, all that shit, bro. I can really rap, bro. So.
And then I was also wondering how they was.
With me.
I was also wondering if he was in.
He might have some kind of contractual stipulations.
I was wondering if he was in good standing with them because I can't see how his stuff really sold like a whole lot for them.
I mean, he got a fan base. The type of shit he talk about, it's kind of like how Drake. You know what I mean? Drake was talking about relationship type of shit.
No. Just, Drake have hits, bro. Boogie don't have like. That's not,
I mean,
no. Listen, man. Okay.
I mean, not
let's
he
okay.
Got signed, bro.
First off,
bro is dope though.
I ain't
frontin'. You know what I mean? Bro is dope. He can rap. He be saying some shit, bro. Like, he lyrical as a motherfucker, bro. Like, that's why he over there now. Maybe as a person, how he act towards people or whatever, like niggas might be like, okay, he kind of, but you know, I'm a fan of the game like you. He can rap, bro. And then I respect that he just rap about shit that pertains to him. You know what I mean?
Right,
his
right,
personal life
right,
and shit
right,
like
right.
that, you know?
See, I was wondering.
And they seen something in him if they signed him, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's just like a nigga in the NBA. A nigga in the NBA for nothing.
Well, see, technically, Well, see, to me, technically, all them niggas over there is like, it seemed like.
You know, they have Slaughterhouse.
It seemed like they not doing what they supposed to do. It seemed like they not doing what they supposed to do over there. It's that record label. It's,
I mean,
Eminem.
Now, with the Griselda shit, because, you know, Conway and Gunn, they signed to Shady. And then Benny
is
signed to Rock Nation, though.
Is that shit really popping? Is that shit really popping? The Griselda shit?
To me,
I mean, it's hard.
It's hard to y'all.
Cause
you know he got the fashion.
Have you heard some bitches playing?
You like the bitches, boy. Nah, I mean, far as like being on some versatile
shit. You know
shit,
what I'm talking about? Regular bitches.
Nah.
I know hip hop bitches.
Yeah. But that's only like a certain. It may be the same for me. Only certain people fuck with my shit. I don't think I'm in that realm to where everybody fuck with my shit, because you gotta be kind of intelligent or understand the complex shit. You gotta be into that type. A lot of, you know, the music now is about a vibe. Like, they not trying to be all overwhelmed with wordplay and lyrics and all that other shit. It's all about the vibe and the beat. they don't
overwhelmed with work.
Nah, they don't care. I know this, you know what I'm saying? But I can't help it because I'm from that era.
I feel you.
They don't care.
I feel you.
I know this, you know what I'm saying?
I feel you, bro.
That's why I'm surprised that people even fuck with me, that I'm getting the feedback that I'm getting, you know what I'm saying? I feel like I was doomed from the jump because I already know what I'm trying to do. Like,
And I
can't compromise for nothing less. Like, I feel like that mumble rap shit, that shit is beneath me. Like, a lot of these niggas is dumb to me. Then they talk about a lot of shit that they ain't even living. All this shoot 'em up shit. These niggas is bitches for real. They ain't did none of that. You know,
You know what, though?
But that's what sells.
But you know what the thing about, I think, about rhyming shit that you not living? I feel like if you rhyme the shit that you not living, you cast a spell through your words and you will be living it.
That part. you put up the energy
even,
out.
I wasn't
That's
even.
That's real. Tell these niggas.
Even, I wasn't
tell
even
these niggas.
Lean.
Y'all
I
better
wasn't
listen,
even
bro.
Having lean and shootouts.
Y'all better listen.
Sudden,
this, y'all better listen to this
shootouts.
Shit, bro. Y'all putting that energy out, bro. Y'all gonna have to live it. One day somebody gonna test y'all because they listen to this shit, so they figure y'all like that. So a nigga might come to your show and press you, be like, what's happening? Like, then what you going to do? Then what you going to do? You not in the booth. You not in the studio. You just in the street shit. It's niggas that's in the streets. They don't know nothing about 16s, bar counts, cadence, lyrical delivery, none of that. They own that shit you talking about. Like,
I'd be fascinated after motherfuckers that's just like I said,
how KRS-One had me as a vegan when I was a young nigga coming up. I was a vegan.
Yeah, music is very influential,
niggas
bro.
Niggas out here like, nigga, I'm going to get
that
some
shit
lean.
Is powerful.
What kind of lean do I need?
Future
to get?
Fuck niggas' heads up.
Activist. Okay, I gotta get activist.
Get the
I gotta get some powder.
Gotta get the concoction.
I gotta put on the Gucci flip flops and be fucking. I gotta Man. Let myself do it.
I gotta look at the lean.
And I'm embodying future.
I'm doing it.
I'm really doing it.
56 nights.
On your Nipsey, you ain't never had an actress on the floor.
Yeah. I'm reliving.
Hey, music is powerful, bro. Words is powerful, period. It's influential,
bro. I think I did, like, back in the days. I don't know if y'all heard this song, AZ Sugar Hill. I want to watch out the Marriott. Only co-op. Nigga, I was in the Marriott doing the exact scene. I'm in the watch. I might as well. I'm in the watch at the Marriott. With the bitch right there. I'm doing
man,
all that.
You felt like AZ for a minute. Hell, you got damn right. You felt like Sugar Hill. Rather do that than some old bullshit. Hell yeah. Damn right. That's that shit, bro. That shit that's what I liked about. That's why I'm a big fan of East Coast lyricism. They talk about a lot of ignorant shit too, but just the way they construct it.
They give you some visual.
It's very articulate.
How you in there.
And then like, I grew up on the West Coast. A lot of these rappers is bitches to me. Like they talk all this shit. They not really like that. Like, and then it's so simplistic the way they word it. Like, I like I mean, the Most High blessed me with this mind. I like that complex shit. I like when I break the word down and the bar down and I get it. Like wow. And that motherfucker cold for that. That shit is everything for me, bro. So I try to get that same feel when I rhyme. When I rhyme, construct my bars and shit. Like, I know niggas ain't gonna always get it, but the niggas that do get it and DM me, like, man, you said this, that shit was cold. Like, that shit is everything for me, bro. Like, that's more than money. Like, that's more than money. That shit is priceless, bro. Like, that's all I'm trying to do, man.
Just all look. Right, bro. Well, shit, man. We 2:16, 2 hours 16.
Man. Yeah, man. Shout out to Boss Mac, man.
It's all good, man.
Compton Righteous, man. Get you some shit. Get
I
you some merch.
I appreciate y'all
man.
Niggas coming out, man.
Tapping them on nigga, man. Real great. Tapping them on nigga Picasso. Y'all know what it is.
Niggas took out the Duce.
Oh, that shit is gone, bro. That shit is out of here.
That
shit is out of here.
Alright, man.
Much love, big dog. Appreciate you having me here, man. We gonna, you know what I mean, we gonna keep building, man. We gonna keep working. You know that.
Alright, bro. Well, that's it.
Yes, that's sir.
Right. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming out. The Top Mac Nigga Show is a Boss Mac Industries production. Put your hands together for a special musical guest. I ain't gonna even say no names.
Keep riding, riding. Oh, forever promise I'ma ride. For my brothers, I'm about to slide. I'ma hold it down, riding, riding. Wanna have my family live a better life, and I won't back down, I won't freeze. I'ma do whatever the fuck I need. Gotta have my family make sure they eat. Gotta have my family make sure they eat. I'ma do what I gotta do. Do what I gotta do. I'ma do what I gotta do. I'ma do what I gotta do. Gotta do.
On my Jordan, on my Kobe,
Louis on my Scotty fucking Pippin. Swishing on my James Bond, double heavy 07. Doing what I have to do, got me praying up to heaven. Asking the most high, help me see the things I'm missing. Stop the killing, start the healing. Manifest your life through talents we've been given. 1 million, then a billion. Came from struggles and days dealing. Grocery store stealing just to eat. See, things get hard when you raised up in the streets. Get sick and tired of seeing my brothers killed. Rest in peace, left deceased by the bitch, motherfucking sheriff and the bitch police. Lying ain't been about shit. Steady while I'm riding, fully loaded with the clip. Trying to keep it stashed, trying to make sure that I get the bag. Trying to help my brothers get and survive up through this path that we've been destined. Guarantee we show you this is greatness. Good type of feel, got you feeling all the base shit. Hustle off the way quick.
Forever promise I'ma ride. For my brothers, I'm about to slide. I'ma hold it down, riding, riding. Wanna have my family live a better life, and I won't back down, I won't freeze. I'ma do whatever the fuck I need. Gotta help my family make sure they eat. Gotta help my family make sure they eat. I'ma do what I gotta do. Do what I gotta do. I'ma do what I gotta do. I'ma do what I gotta do.
Ways to the pen and the page. Erykah Badu playing other side of the game. I let the Frankie Myrrh burn with a sprinkle of sage. The lights about joint pain like Frankie Beverly and Maze. It's for my niggas in the cage, upstate in the rage. It's for the dead homie slain 6 feet in the grave. It's dedication, meditation that be keeping me sane. My preparation's revelation, living in these last days. My granny told me it's gonna be tough, but you gon' make it. Born gifted like Wale, you a special since a baby. Know the devil is a lie, you tell the truth and you gon' shame. I'm painting a portrait with my words. Picasso, the illustrator, innovator, contemplating them cables, pursuing paper. Young nailer, nigga, born to ride like a crusader. Though that Nipsey Hussle won't his own for motivation. They gon' give me my respect, or I'm gon' take it. I'm gon' take it.
Forever promise I'ma ride. For my brothers, I'm about to slide. I'ma hold it down, riding, riding. Wanna have my family live a better life, and I won't back down, I won't freeze. I'ma do whatever the fuck I need. Gotta have my family make sure they eat. Gotta have my family make sure they eat. I'ma do what I gotta do. Do what I gotta do. I'ma do what I gotta do. I'ma do what I gotta do.